Welcome back to One Run. Today I'm playing Fall Guys, but if I fall, the video ends. Count me down, Jack.
3, 2, 1, go! We finally got him to do it!
Yeah! I refuse.
Part 3, baby!
Yeah! I refused for so long.
It is.
Now I'm back.
The only game we've ever had somebody say no to.
Yeah.
Turn it down a little bit.
Well, at the beginning of this, I thought I was going to be a bit more discriminatory.
At the beginning of this, I thought I was going to be more discriminatory.
Ooh, welcome back to One Run. Today I'm playing Cat Mario, but if I die, the video ends. Count me down, Cameron.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right, you ready?
Here we go.
Look out! Oh. Ah! Hello and welcome to One Run, where today we're playing Doom, but if I die, the video ends. Count me down, Reese.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right, start the clock. We're in.
Doom.
Okay.
This is on ultraviolet, so it's really.
Yeah. You just said ultraviolet. We all heard it. That's a color.
It's not a color.
I need to get the.
You're
boost.
A color.
Yeah,
oh my God, he's making it.
Calm down.
He's doing it. And he's.
Time.
Oh wow.
Right, come on, world record.
How do you get 10% kills? Do you get any kills?
I think someone must have fallen in the lava.
Hey, you come back out!
Alright, I can do it better than that, but we'll have to do it on the next channel. Alright. Do you want to hear a really sad fact?
You practiced the speed
run? Oh, yeah! I practiced a 10-second run. Welcome to... yeah. Like when we were talking about games earlier, I suggested doing modern Doom, right?
Yeah.
Doom 2016. Then I was like, well, but I could do the fucking first level speedrun. That'd be really funny, wouldn't it? And that's when I was like, I think we should do the original. I think that would make for a good video.
Are you sure you were even having troubles with Burnout Paradise?
don't even. Wait, no, Cam, that video's not out.
Don't give it away.
Oh, which
we're
was
still
the game?
Doing Burnout Paradise.
Which did we replace with Doom? Monster Prom?
Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
You could have got Monster Prom. You could have got.
Yeah.
You could have got the Monster Prom. Quick speed, quick boy. Quick run, speed run.
Right.
Hello, my name is Reese. I'm trying to complete the Doom Quick Speed Quick Boy.
I'm pretty sure Quick Speed Quick Boy was the fifth train spotting guy.
Games done, Quick Speed Quick Boy.
Right, so since we have a bit of breathing room, it's time we addressed it. Cam is in a weird mood.
I'm excited! It's the end of One Run!
Woo! Can't wait to kill it!
Woo! Also, no, I'll tell you the real, like, reason.
See what I mean?
There's a couple of things. One, I am excited to send this amazing channel off.
To its grave.
Where it will doom.
Nice. That was good.
It wasn't good.
Moving on.
But also, there is a difference between me in the last session and me now, which is I have ascended. I am no longer a broke boy. The law has continued.
Daddy's trust fund finally unlocked.
I have a job. I have an adult job.
For the time being, you had two jobs.
Also, you had a job with me.
Yes. Yeah. And we talked about video games all day.
Shut up.
I mean, it was our job to talk about video games all day. You can't just cough during ultraviolet.
Violet. Stop saying violet.
It's okay. These demons ain't got shit. So yeah, Cam, you got a new job.
Yes.
What are all your co-workers' full names and addresses?
Wow, that is...
Where do you work and what's your rota?
Oh, jeez. It's super important, guys, that I don't say anything. Oh?
Cam's a spy. He works for MI6 now.
It'd be hard to like narrow it down because Tesco's is 24-hour. No disrespect to people who work at Tesco, but the idea that you would be very excited about getting a fucking retail Tesco job.
I mean, look, maybe it pays well, you know?
It doesn't.
Shit. Okay. Whoa!
Man, this game's really easy. I don't know why people struggle with Doom, you know?
Did you practice more than just the first level?
No, but I practiced the first level a lot.
Oh, fair.
I've never actually played this game
You're
before.
Doing pretty well.
I've legitimately never played the first Doom before.
Is it weird to play a game with a mouse that you can't look up and down?
I keep going to do it, yeah. Mm-hmm. I keep, like, I'm doing it all the time. It's just having no effect.
I always thought this game would work better on controller just because, like, you wouldn't have to have the temptation of looking up and down as much, you know?
There is a...
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Ooh! There is a port, I mean...
Who's Ghosty? Who's Ghost Boy?
He's dead. Don't worry, I killed him.
No, 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 I killed you. I've killed your soul.
I know realistically that technology, where you're, like, almost invisible, would be very useful. But it always seems like, man, you could have taken it a step further to full invisibility.
Have you seen those videos of people that kind of have it?
What?
Yeah.
What, invisibility?
No, with ghosts. You know those videos where people have ghosts? No, they've got like mirror suits on, and they like it actually kind of works if they're lying down.
I remember
it's
as
really
a
sick.
Kid, I watched this awesome documentary where like the camera was in one of those mirror boxes, so all the animals would interact normally, like because they couldn't tell the camera was there. And I bet if I go back and watch that now as an adult, it looks super fucking obvious. But as a kid, I was like,
probably
whoa.
Not to a penguin, though.
No, 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 no. But like, I remember being like, why don't we do
not
this all
young,
the time?
A young Cameron who has the same mind as a penguin.
Cam's like, where's the camera? How are they doing this?
Cam sees images come out of a box, and he's like, whoa.
I gotta go to college for media and figure this out. Oh, guys, I saw Proto Us in town.
Oh, really?
It was really cute, yeah. I was just, like, standing outside the college trying to pick up a new assistant. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck, no!
What a creepy way to die! Welcome back to One Run. Today I'm playing Burnout Paradise, but if I crash, the video ends. Count me down, Reese.
3, 2, 1, go!
And go! All right, Cam. Have you played this game before?
Yeah, when it first came out for like PS2, PS3?
PS3, I think. Did you play it much?
I don't really remember anything of it. I just know that I played it. And I remember jumping over a
rock. Oh, you fucking idiot. Hello and welcome to One Run, where today we're playing Subway Surfers, but if they are the arsehole, the video ends. Count me down, Cam.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right, I'm in.
Shall we explain?
Nope.
Okay. Off you go, Cam.
I'm reading something. This isn't me. Am I the asshole for refusing to leave my house? My wife and I were golden up until 3 months ago. Okay, I completely mispronounced that. My wife and I were golden up until 3 months ago.
My wife and I were golden up.
Okay, this first paragraph is already feeling
awful.
Are you
reading the newest one?
Yeah, 3 minutes ago.
Oh, mine's different.
Maybe there was newer posts. Yeah. Like, yeah.
My wife and I were golden up until 3 months ago when she gave birth to our first child. Her third, my first. Ever since then,
doesn't sound like they were
it's been a complete shit show. Everything is a problem.
Don't have kids!
She gets pissed when I tell my stepkids not to be all over the baby. She says I'm causing her kids to react and not bond with the baby because of my ignorance, because it's not like they're kissing her or whatever. When I tell the kids they aren't...
It's hard for me to get a gauge what the story is because Cam's like... It's offbeat way of like saying
there's a lot of quotation marks in
this
story.
It's like he's reading in a different language, just phonetically sounding it out.
She says I'm causing her kids to react and not bond with the baby because of my ignorance, because it's not like they're kissing her, or whenever I tell the kids that they're touching electronics that way.
What?
He's also spelling like me, so it's really hard to read. Okay, I'll tell them to clean or pretty much anything else. She gets pissed because she already told them to do something else, and I'm overstepping her. Or, if I ask the kids repetitive questions when she's trying to nurse the baby, I will answer for her.
Cam! You know what? You're the arsehole!
You know the people on, like... We see it, do it. Like, they're so smooth with it, and like, I can understand exactly what's happening.
Okay. So basically... I'll just summarize what I failed to read so far.
What was happening?
It's so strange that we have to end this channel because Cam has a job at Smosh.
he's like overparenting the kids, basically. And I'll keep reading from here. She's nursing the baby, so often I have to speak to the kids a lot and say she is starting to fucking hate me.
Ow.
Because I'm constantly speaking for her and trying to keep her kids away from her. Basically, she is being accusing me of trying to ruin her mum bond with her kids now that I have a child of my own, and has accused me of wanting a kids should be seen not heard house ever since the baby arrived, and she's fucking sick of my attitude towards her kids since then. things that I do not see an issue with at all, and 100% feel like she's over-exaggerating the issue. She's brought it up several times since having the baby, and I would change if there was an actual issue, but there isn't. She's finding problems. So here's the big one. Okay, so this is the big paragraph now. Last night, I was in the living room, and my wife...
Can I put you on pause for a sec? Because the premise is, am I the arsehole for not leaving the house, right? So... Yeah. Even though he's definitely an arsehole now, that it's not what he's asking. So if he's not an arsehole for the leaving the house part, we're good, and we get to keep doing this really, really fun idea that I don't want to stop after one story.
Also, I will say, my reading has been so awful. He could have been so, so, like, different to what this is, but we'll find out.
It's like, we look at it later.
So reasonable. Yeah, we're looking at it later. It's like,
my wife stabbed me.
Everything I say in quotation marks is like a third guy I never mentioned. Okay. Last night, I was in the living room, and my wife was in the kitchen with her oldest, and he kept asking a bunch of questions, and she was giving a damn near constant, I don't know, answer to the questions. Questions she truly couldn't answer, because we don't have the answers to said questions. So I stepped in, and told her son to go to the other room. She immediately snapped her head in my direction, and said, "There you fucking go again, why don't you leave?" I was kind of taken aback by this and told her, no, I absolutely would not leave my house. So she walks to the kids' room.
Maybe he is a bit of an asshole for not leaving his house.
So she walks to the kids' room.
Can is on you, by the way.
Tells them to start packing.
I was so excited about this.
And then goes.
Stop within like 3 minutes.
And then goes to our room and starts packing. I asked her if she was really about to rip the kids out of the house over stupid shit, and she said yes she was, because I wouldn't leave and I'm making everyone hate life. Am I the asshole for refusing to leave? My buddy said I should have just left, because even if my wife was wrong, her hormones are screwed right now.
I was waiting for the hormone retort.
So here's the thing.
Okay.
Basically, what's happening here, from what I could, before we get our verdicts in, is that she has two kids independent of him. Then they have a kid together.
Yeah.
He is like overparenting the two kids that aren't his by being like, you shouldn't ask too many stupid questions. You shouldn't, you know, mess with the baby.
And I feel like the implication is he wasn't like that before they had their own baby.
Yes. Yeah. I feel like that, or maybe another version of this could be that he never had to parent those kids before the mother is now very busy with the newborn and he's having to actually step up. That's just an interpretation,
yeah,
maybe.
I suppose it's not details either way, right?
Yeah. And the big one for me is that when the kid is innocently like asking, oh, why is the sky blue? Why is this? He's like, oh, we can't have that. That kid needs to go in the other room and stop asking all these unnecessary questions.
Like, bro, she'll tell the kid that if the kid's annoying her.
Just sounds
like a controlling fucking asshole.
Wasn't there like a bit as well?
I mean,
like
a controlling, reasonable guy that we should all listen to.
Did you say there's a bit where he wouldn't allow the older kids to see the young?
Basically, yeah, there was a bit here where the kids are... He's saying that his wife is complaining because he keeps telling the kids to stop, like, fussing over the new baby, because he's worried that they're gonna like mess with the new baby or stuff, and the wife is interpreting that as like, why don't you want the kids to like know their little brother, little sister? I'm not sure the gender of the baby, but like I could go either way on that, because again, we don't get details on what the kids are doing. If they're like punching the new baby, then fair enough.
You should definitely check the comments as well to see if the guy expands and like explains. Yeah. I mean, there probably aren't questions though, because it's new.
Because
right?
It's like, it's common for like them to tell that the older kid to be a bit calmer around the new kid, but like taking away access to the child is a bit.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it's unreliable narrator, but yeah, if they're like drop kicking the baby, you have a right to say, hey, maybe don't be so rough with
the baby. I feel like if, because it's his perspective, right? So like if he's
carry on,
perspective,
he's stopped. Like,
it's Pavlovian, dude. Honestly,
so if he's telling the story, I feel like he would include they were dropkicking. I feel like he wants to make himself come off as... This is the thing,
if he wants to make himself come off as not the arsehole, he is doing a very bad job of that.
Yeah. Now, I will say again, this is me reading, so my comprehension is terrible, but I think we got the gist of it. And I think we're all ready to make our
Can I just say before we make our verdicts?
Yes.
I'd like to... We've played Subway Surfers a few times in this channel, and every single time I insult Zoomers. Every single time, without fail. And I would just like to apologize because...
You were enthralled, weren't you?
Legitimately, that is the most I've ever listened to. I was hanging on every word.
For better or worse. I was hanging on every deconstructed sentence.
I'm not even joking. I was, completely in my zen place playing Subway Surfers and just enjoying listening to you read a story. You know how... This channel was born from a show we used to do on another channel.
Yeah.
Can this be another channel born from...
For it. Yeah. I will say, goofy as it is, the idea of doing a Let's Play of Subway Surfers while reading Out of the Asshole is actually fucking genius. It's the expression of the form.
This is how it starts.
Anyway, I think he's an asshole.
No, I think he's all right.
Because I think, yes, okay, it's a little complicated because, should you really have him leave the house? But he's an adult. He can be outside the house for a little bit. What she really needed was space, right? And he was like, no, I'm not going to give you space. Because, Jen's never asked me to leave the house, but if she did, it's not going to be the end of the world for me. I'll just go for a walk, you know?
Get fucked, Jen. Wow. The end of the world.
You hearing this?
Plenty more fish in the
sea. I
deem you, Cameron, the asshole.
And now your video ends. Here's the thing. I'm going to apply my own rule. I don't think he's an asshole for not leaving the house. I think he's an asshole for literally everything else in that story. But no, I think... And okay, maybe I'm stretching it a little bit. But if it's fucking take a lap, I need time to cool down, just do that. You know what I mean? For your own sake, just do that as well. But if it's leave and don't come back, or leave for a week and find some place to stay, no, you're probably not the arsehole because you don't want to fucking sleep on the street, and that might not be fair. Mm. Can you tell I am jumping through so many hoops?
It's a stretch.
I think he is.
I don't think he should. Yeah, basically, what you're saying is, though, he shouldn't have left. He was right for making her and the kids leave.
You know what? I will fall on this sword because I want to do at least one more story. So I think this guy, he's a saint, honestly. He was doing them a favor.
Okay, Reese, what's your opinion? Is he the asshole?
I think he's the asshole.
Okay. So Jack doesn't think that guy's the asshole, so we'll move on to the next one.
I promise I will only do that once. I just really didn't think the first one would be that cut and dry.
I mean, look, you worked your way out of it. I do believe you believe what you said.
No. So I'd rather end the video.
If you'll read the next one.
Ooh, so the newest one that's come out is like three paragraphs.
Okay.
And that's it. Do we read that one?
Dealer's choice. Just pick an interesting title.
Ooh, let's have a look. One's called Am I the Asshole for Snapping at Man?
That'll do.
Let's hear it.
Yeah, okay, we'll do it for snapping at man. Okay.
I'm just gonna say, calling my shot, I don't think man did anything wrong.
Reese, if you want me to look really good and redeem myself, please act like you can't read.
I'll be all over it. Weird.
Sounds like Christopher Walken showed up for a second.
Had a weird interaction at the post office today. I was at the counter being served, posting a parcel. The post office employee asks me, as they're obliged to, what is inside the parcel. I reply that it's a book, and the employee processes the parcel. Note, this is a very small post office, although with 6 or 7 customers in the queue waiting behind me, being deathly silent.
Okay.
At this time, I hear the voice of a customer in the queue behind me shout over, "What book is it?"
Legend.
That's Legend. Any post office in Wales.
That's really funny.
What book in?
Go on, share out. What are you reading?
Share the class. I was kind of startled. And a bit disgruntled that someone in the queue was not only listening to my transaction, but wanted to poke their nose into my business and involve the whole room. I turned around and snapped at them and told them to mind their own business. As I was trying to conduct my transaction. After I did this, it became apparent that the man involved appeared to be neurologically diverse.
Oh,
in
no.
some way. And he muttered that he likes to read books.
Oh, this boy!
I should have picked this one because we're going to end really soon!
Oh.
And he madly liked to read books. I think he just wanted to have a conversation about books and looked genuinely saddened by my reaction. But his approach was startling and untimely. Am I the arsehole for telling this man to mind his own business?
I need you to fall on the sword, Cam.
As I was reading it, I was like, this is fine. Oh, fuck.
When you read the title and we're getting into it, I was like, oh, this is going to be all right. We'll be safe with this one.
Yeah. It'll be a guy fucking mouthing off at a woman.
Yeah, just be really creepy in the post office. But even...
It's easy. This is a home run. But no, she shouted at a guy who likes books.
Yeah, for talking about
books. Shut the fuck up about books, you nerd.
It's so... actually the arsehole. Even without the neurodivergent stuff, which just makes the story a bit sadder.
Yeah.
Even if the guy just wanted to talk about books.
No, what book?
Fine. What there's book? Nothing wrong with that. It's totally reasonable.
What book is it? Go fuck yourself.
It's one of them books. But Cam, I need you. I've never asked you for anything.
Oh. So here's the thing.
Don't talk to strangers, yeah?
I want to start by saying this guy is not in the wrong at all.
Yeah.
This guy, he didn't do anything wrong. I don't think he deserved to be snapped at all. But the question is the person an arsehole for snapping? It's not, was he wrong?
Yeah, you it's know, not was who's the arsehole. Yeah, it's am it's, I the arsehole?
Yeah. So if I'm going to fall on the sword, then what I guess I would say is that this, you know, people move through lives a lot. And I'm not going to make it a gender thing. A lot of people, you know, get harassed a lot of times by people snapping at them, saying things, you know. I mean, I guess it depends on your experience, but it can be stressful when someone just says something that could sound sarcastic.
No, I'll be honest. I've been in that situation myself where I've just had my guard up when I shouldn't have, you know. And no, I haven't snapped at somebody, but I've, like, not done... the nice thing of, like, talking to the person or engaging with the person. So I get it. I haven't got enough keys, Cam.
Do I think that this person was, you know, it was inappropriate for you to snap? Maybe. Arsehole, though.
It's a big word, right?
It is a big word. Especially mine.
I'm going to say right now, there are 11 comments already.
Okay.
Only two of them say you're not your arsehole.
Well, luckily, those two are on one run.
Yeah.
You asked me to fall on the sword, so I'm going to say this. I wouldn't go as far to say you're an arsehole because you seem genuinely remorseful and regretful. And I don't think it was an arsehole move. I think it was a move made out of frustration. And you've clearly, like, learned from it.
Yeah.
You know?
I will say, now that I know that you definitely will fall on this sword and we can keep doing this awesome,
I can still switch.
Idea.
I haven't said.
I will say.
I did actually say.
Yeah. You said those exact words. I think there is something off-putting about the way they've worded this story.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because they bury the lead... and make the guy sound way worse than he is until you get to the end.
Well, because
of the story.
They're trying to give you their experience.
I suppose.
You know? Which is, I feel like, the most authentic way to do
think
it.
If if you think about it from their point of view, it's somebody's just chirping at them from behind.
Yeah. Because if they had said, I walked into, you know, the post office and there was a guy who loved books behind me, and then they carried on with the story, you would have been like, well, you knew he liked books, but they didn't.
Guy, this guy clearly loved his books. After what book it was, I said, go fuck yourself.
Yeah.
I'm on the arsehole for that.
I suppose. Yeah. I do. It's
tough because, like, technically, yeah, you are the arsehole for that, but, like, you didn't really know the situation. You just acted a bit rashly.
This is one of those situations where I'm like, I don't think most people are like this, but there is a small amount of people, I think, online who tend to be, like, very black or white with moral judgments like this. And I think that, yeah. And I think that this is a problem, right? Because, like, I like the term, you know, there are no arseholes in this story. Because it's like, really, you did something wrong, but I don't think you were the arsehole. Like, I don't think I would call my friend an arsehole if they told me this story. I'd be like, oh, you probably should have thought about that a bit more, you know?
Yeah, it's worth noting that Cam has known me for a very long time at this point, and it has skewed his scale a little bit. But, not the arsehole!
Hey, next up, Cameron.
Oh, yeah, it's me. I thought you were like, Cameron, are you an arsehole?
Look, I'm gonna say that everybody watching this is definitely having as much fun as we are. And they'll be delighted that we stretched it a little bit to do
one. Sure, yeah. How many deaths is that now?
Fucking, I don't know. It stopped mattering to me after the first
time. Okay, guys, I hope you don't mind it, but I'm going to look for a shorter one because I don't believe in my reading comprehension.
Again, just go based on titles.
Oh, God, that is so dark. I'm not going there.
Can you at least read the, title?
I mean, I'll no, we can go with this one if we want the end the video.
Well, we don't know. I mean, don't pick one definitely that's an asshole, okay. I suppose. Pick one that could go either way.
Oh, yeah, that, yeah, I think I know that one.
What's the title?
It was just, am I an asshole for feeling terrified about this sad, pathetic generation that will soon ruin this country? Posted by Super Mars World. okay.
I wanted to do that. Today's recording session was a little bit short notice, which is fine, but I was fully planning on pre-typing one and just at the start of this video posting it real quick and hoping you guys to find it in new.
Okay, this one could go either way. I like this one. Am I the asshole for moving stuff around on my sister's desk?
Oh, all right, great.
Let's get some initial thoughts before I read.
First off, yeah.
See, on me, it's a no. I feel like that's a fun brother-sister,
brother-brother thing. All the fucking time.
That's true.
But that's the thing. True. Like,
if I walk,
I love that you said, one of you said yes, one of you said no, but I'm completely in the middle because, like, yeah, you kind of are, but also I love it.
I feel, yeah, maybe Reese has got a point. Like, if I walked in and my sister had moved my desk around once, I'd be like, that's kind of funny. You know, Neve, you didn't need to do that, but that's kind of funny.
How much. Like, but if you moved it into another room, you might be a little bit annoyed.
If my sister tortured me, basically, by never knowing where any of my stuff was going to be, we'll read. We'll see. We'll see. Let's, you know.
You'll try to read and we'll try to listen.
Yeah, we'll try to figure it out.
Yeah.
Wow, the age gap is... Oh, it's not exact to my sister, but it's close. So I'm going to be able to relate to this. So I, male, 15, have a little sister, female, 12.
You really agree?
I was a 15-year-old male at one point.
Fucking 28,
with a younger sister.
I can relate to being 15.
I cannot think of an age I relate to less than 15.
You guys don't watch, like, coming-of-age movies? And I'm like, oh, I remember being that.
No.
I mean, but move on, carry on.
So I, male 15, have a little sister, female 12, and we get along pretty well. Never any stupid big fights and whatnot. Today, today,
there it is.
Fuck me.
Wait.
Today, as a I thought funny, haha, prank, rearranged some stuff on her desk. I put her laptop upside down.
Oh, okay.
I moved a jar from the corner to the middle of the desk.
That's so fucking tame.
I put her mouse up my ass. No, I'm just kidding. I put her mouse upside down. You literally put it upside. Right, like down. Two different words.
Love it.
And a couple other things.
That's why Cam can relate.
And she yells at me, "What did you do to my desk?" And so I came down and pretended like I didn't do it. I put her Apple keyboard in her bed. And she said, unless it was magic that it got there, I don't know how I did it. And I thought it would be really funny, so I said, I mean, it is an Apple magic keyboard. And she told me to get out of her room. Now, my room is next to hers. She is in tears, talking to our mom about how she just rearranged her desk and she wanted it to look nice. And I'm wondering if I took it too far. I'm a guy.
I'm just an ordinary fella.
It's like a quote from Ken from the Barbie movie. Yeah. I'm a guy. So I'm not sure if I think the way she does, but I think she's being dramatic for crying over this. She won't talk to me. She won't talk to B, but I ask my mom.
Is it spelt ma'am?
It's spelled mom.
What about not to be? Will she talk to me?
I asked my mom, and she said that she's crying because I lied to her face and gaslit her.
Oh, come on.
But I think it's pretty obvious. I did it and just tried to make comedic jokes. I don't feel like I did anything crazy, and I'm not really in trouble, but my sister is really mad at me. In my opinion, for what?
Do you know what I love about that story? Is that because obviously he's 15, so it like in the it, like, it's such a nothing story.
Yeah.
But because you're 15, it's like, oh, this is like my world is
the
falling.
Most important thing.
Yeah, my world is falling apart right now.
Here's the thing, I really struggle with the story because he said at the beginning that him and his sister like have never had big fights, never fallen out.
Yeah.
That is not the experience I have. With my sister, like
just fucking putting her on blast.
No. It was like we were kids. Like it's no one's fault. But like, you know, siblings, like they fight. They, you know, they have disagreements. Yeah. You know, you're like, ah, what do? You do this. You do this. You know. So like, when he was like, me and my sister are cool as fuck. I was like, I don't know where to go with this because like I know that if I did this to my sister, it would be par for the course. It would be like, okay, you know. This is, we did this, she did this, I did this, she did this. You don't even know who started, who fired the first shot.
It's all he said, she said. Kind of.
Yeah.
But this is a case where it's like, they've been perfect siblings, and then suddenly he was like, chaos.
I have a few thoughts. One, I'm very disappointed that I had to hear from a 15-year-old today. That's just a shame. Didn't really want that. But, despite that, I'm quite impressed, again, assuming the story is true, right? And it, like, he's not unreliable narrator or whatever. I am quite impressed with the level of maturity shown. Like, it is a nothing prank.
Yeah.
It's just a bit of fun. And the conversation really should be, I don't like that, don't do that again. Okay, sorry, I won't. That should be it. But when you're fucking 15 and 12, everything's the most... Like
the
you
world's
said.
Ruined. Yeah.
I think the mother's fucked up.
For saying the sun casts.
Yeah.
Well, you don't know, because the...
But here's the... Let me just finish my thought. The part that he included of, like... We dunked on it, but saying, like, I'm a guy, so maybe I don't understand how she's feeling. Like, fair play. Like, to acknowledge that people have different world experiences and what's fun for you might not be fun for someone else. So, he seems relatively reasonable for a 15-year-old. Yeah. And I can't believe the mother accused him of gaslighting. That is insane.
I mean, it's tough, right? Because it's like... Like, we don't know how he said that. Like, the Apple Magic keyboard bit really doesn't feel...
By the way.
It really doesn't feel like he was gaslighting her. It feels more like he was being very obvious that it was him, despite saying it wasn't. But I can see a world where that plays out a little bit differently, and he really is like, no, I didn't do anything. I swear to God. And that is gaslighting.
It was a wizard, okay?
Now, I don't think 15-year-olds should, like... be called assholes.
On the internet. Oh, sorry.
Should be called assholes for doing something like that because, like, that's something you learn, right? And the parent obviously wanted to teach that lesson. But I do think the way that he put it, at least, and again, unreliable narrator.
Almost.
It sounded like he was being very obvious. But again, his sister's 12, so maybe she fully did, like, believe him when he said that he didn't do it, especially if they've never fought.
Here's the thing, I don't think he's an asshole, and I don't think the sister's an asshole. I just think the mother's an asshole. Like, because that just, I don't know, that paints such a strange perception of what gaslighting is for this kid now. Do you know what I mean? And it's quite a fucking serious thing to accuse someone of.
But again, it could have been akin to gaslighting, but it didn't sound like it when he wrote it. But like, I can see where that situation... you know, does sound a bit more. If especially if she's gotten the sister's account of it.
Yeah, well, that's you know? What I was thinking. Is like, well, as a parent, get your son's side of the story as well and then make that call. Because the sister is now an unreliable narrator.
I'm not about to criticize a parent as not a parent.
Oh, dude,
myself.
I will do that fucking... I hate parents.
Look, I mean, it's a learning experience for the two kids, you know? Nobody's the arsehole yet.
Yeah. Nobody's the arsehole yet except the person who decided to bring a child into this fucking world.
Jesus Christ.
Alright.
All the parents I know are cool. If I know you personally and you have kids, we're cool. If I don't know you personally and you have kids, go fuck yourself.
Jesus Christ!
Or if you like other videos, that's
fine. You're glad that you're not here? Because you would have been the arsehole. Can I quickly, while Reese is reading, write this encounter?
Am I the arsehole for having a weird hatred of children?
Jesus Christ. I'm gonna say not the arsehole. But again, I don't think anyone was the arsehole in that story. I think it was just a learning experience of growing up. You know, you're gonna fight with your siblings and, you know, at least, you know, it all worked out in the end.
It's funny you say that, like, that's not your relationship with your siblings, because it kind of was with mine, at least growing up.
Oh, really?
Well, there's 10 years between me and my closest siblings.
Oh, okay.
Like, I'm the youngest, right? So, like, we couldn't really fight. Because they'd kill me.
Bang! <Yeah. laughs>
So I was just kind of babied a lot. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I couldn't really fight my siblings because they weren't that significantly younger, but they were younger. But they would still like, they would like do things to annoy me and at least stuff like this. You know, like
and
this
is like he's a black
anyone.
Belt, so he doesn't want to like unleash his power.
Yeah, he doesn't want to go too hard. Yeah. On me, you know,
he'd lose his license.
His license. His license. He's a practicing karate fucking. Oh, never mind.
All right, Reese, find us an arsehole.
Am I the arsehole for not wanting my husband's niece to stay with us?
Ooh.
My husband and I have been married for 10 years, and we have two little kids. I don't know why they said little, but fine.
Two little kids.
Two tiny little kids that the niece can kill. Like, I don't know.
Two tiny little kids that'll piss off Mars.
When we decided to get married, my sister-in-law, husband's elder brother's wife. Okay.
That sounds like a Dark Souls boss. Yeah.
Husband's elder sister's wife. Yeah, husband's elder brother's wife. Okay, so his older brother's wife.
Okay.
Sister-in-law was pretty mean to me from the very beginning. She was always rude and passive-aggressive to me.
Okay.
And tried to maintain a relationship with my husband and completely cold-shouldered me. She would have her two daughters call my husband and ask him for gifts. Okay.
Wild.
Gradually, we found out that she used to badmouth me to the other relatives, and we reduced contact with them to a point that for many, many years, we were hardly talking.
Okay.
My mother-in-law passed away 4 years ago, and it was a great desire for her that we all get along. Since I loved and respected my mother-in-law a lot, my husband and I tried to mend things with his brother's family. We even paid for a short visit, and things became much better.
Okay, good. Cool. End of story. No one's out.
They returned our visit. Okay. The typing of this is...
Did Cameron write this? Yeah.
They returned from their visit for a couple of years. We maintained contact through visits and phone calls, etc. Since we live in different cities, we visited maybe once a year.
That's still quite a lot.
It's more than I visit anyone.
Since last year, his family has started visiting us for weeks at a time, every few months. Okay. Their elder daughter just started college, and she joined the college in our city, and has taken to visiting us every 2 to 3 weeks or so.
Okay.
And staying for the weekend. Okay.
Jake calls
nothing,
with your family.
Nothing wrong so far.
Now she's planning to do a month-long internship in our city, and is asking to stay at my house. Notice she says my house.
Did they give an age? They've been married for 10 years, so they presumably are like late 20s at least.
Yeah, they didn't give an age, but yeah. Assume we're on that time.
Okay. Real sort of Cameron situation.
Yeah. I'm really uncomfortable with all of this. First of all, I don't feel so close to her that I would be comfortable with her living at my house.
Okay.
There's so much history there that no matter how hard I try to let bygones be bygones, I still can't completely forget my sister-in-law's bad behaviour.
But the niece is coming to stay. It's got nothing to do with her.
I want things to be more neutral. All of a sudden, behaving like best friends with her is not my cup of tea.
But you're not. That's the niece, right?
It says, am I asshole for not wanting my husband's niece to stay with us?
Right.
And the niece is doing an internship for the year.
And you're pissed off at her mother, so...
Yeah. Okay, first of all...
I mean, I assume the story's not done. Is that was at the end of it?
So there's one more sentence. Am I the arsehole for refusing Lucas' request?
Oh, she actually did refuse it?
For wanting to refuse.
Oh, wanting to.
Okay.
Okay.
I mean, the thing is really weird is you say my husband's niece, but isn't it technically your niece as well, unless there's some kind of...
Technically, yeah, because there's a sister-in-law. The sister-in-law was mean to her and badmouthed her, and
it's the sister-in-law's daughter.
It's her
niece.
Daughter.
Yeah,
it's basically her niece.
It feels weird that this whole stuff about like my house and the sister. I mean, look, my house, fair enough. Like I know it sounds weird, but like sometimes you know, you will I'll refer to my house even though it's Chan and I's house, you know, our house, whatever. But the whole like my husband's niece is strange, like. Mm. Just for clarity, because I feel like...
It's oddly relevant to you.
This is relevant. My niece lives with me. And she's my niece, even though she's blood related to my wife, Jenny. It's still my niece. Like, that's how that works, you know? This is strange, because I do think that there are elements where you do have to be conscious of a lot of things. For example, like, having another person in your house for a whole month is expensive. Like, it is just expensive. Even if that person buys food for themselves, there are so many elements that you don't consider to having, like, another person in the house that is expensive. That doesn't sound like this is that person's concern.
No, because she would have included that, right?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
We can't afford to have her stay,
exactly.
Which is totally reasonable.
And also, like, my relationship with my niece has very little to do with, you know, my relationship with her mother. Like, that doesn't... I understand that sometimes the wires can get crossed, but, like, that's on you. Yeah. Like, sometimes the wires can get crossed in your brain and you start associating people with their parents or whatever.
Cam, I've unlocked Tricky.
Nice.
Hell yeah.
But yeah, I think I'm going to go arsehole, just because there are reasons to refuse the niece, but they've given none.
Well, they sort of have, but... They feel like they're leading the witness again of just excluding what she really wants to say, which is, I'm still fucking furious at my sister-in-law and want to punish anything that's even closely related to her. Because, like,
weird.
We keep saying, it's got nothing to do with the daughter at all.
Here's the thing. Here's, this is going to change your perspective, Jack.
Well, we have to find an arsehole soon, because we've been going for about half hour.
No, but I need to mention this, because you were very passionate about this. This person did say they are a parent. So does that make you hate them more?
Oh.
Because you have a strange...
You have a vendetta.
Anger against parents.
I just think there's enough people.
It's like, I don't agree with the parent, but I also don't agree with the child.
It's so tricky because they're both parents.
Well, the niece is the parent.
Good. She's not an arsehole. I mean, arsehole, right? Like...
Reese, you gonna follow this?
There's no way I'm following this one.
I think out of the stories
it's for
here,
a fucking month.
Yeah, that is, yeah, that as well. Like,
it's not the entire time she's in uni. Like, it's for a fucking month.
Like, honestly, bluntly, even if there is more to it than that, like the sister-in-law is being really mean about it, or like, this wasn't in the story, but if she was like, well, she'll come to stay with you, like being really expectant about it. Fucking suck it up. It's got nothing to do with the niece. Do a nice thing.
Yeah.
Do the kind thing and let her stay. And then, I don't know, fucking have a fight with the sister-in-law afterwards.
I gotta say, though, like, I mean, I am saying arsehole, but I am also biased because, like, I you know, my niece is staying with me. And, like, it just feels like it's not a big deal.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it can be a big deal. Again, I told you there's lots of reasons why it can be. And, like, you know, it is a challenge, but they've not made reference to any of the legitimate issues that can come with that.
It was just, I don't like her mother.
Yeah. There was, I was really expecting, like,
yeah, she said, like, oh, we're not that well off.
Yeah.
And it'd be hard for us.
Or
to
we
do
don't
it.
Have the space.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know,
we
but they,
a, yeah, we live in a small, like, flat. You can't really, like, accommodate.
Because that's another thing, is, like, space can be a big issue. Because, again, you might have lots of money, but, like, you don't want to buy a new house.
No,
you know?
But Reese, again, going back to Reese's point, it is just for a month. You think you could figure it out for a month? Like, just let her sleep on the sofa for a month. You know what I mean? There would have to be a lot more details in that story for me to not consider her an arsehole, to be honest. Like, the niece would have to, like, kick a dog or something.
Well, goodness for you, I left out two-thirds of the story, imagine. It turns out that the niece is actually a serial killer, and she brings all her victims to where she's staying.
Not the arsehole. All right, I guess we'll do it on three, then we'll give our verdict.
Okay.
Oh, on one.
We go, you're the arsehole.
Yeah, okay. But we don't know. We might say not the arsehole. Who knows? Okay. It'll go either way. Okay, so...
We should have really done this every single time.
Yeah, we did.
We'll go back.
Yeah, we'll just call them all. Three, two, one, you're the asshole! New channel!
Three, two, one.
Hello to One Run!
Who said hello?
We intro it different, I've just realized. You both say welcome back to One Run, but I always say hello and welcome to One Run.
Oh, no.
It fundamentally can't work. Hello!
And
welcome
back
to
One
Run.
Today,
we're
playing
Who
Wants
to
Be
a
Millionaire.
But
if
we
don't
become
millionaires,
the
video
ends.
Three,
two, one,
go!
That was the hardest thing I've ever done.
His brain is warm.
I forgot not the second half of the challenge. It was like, welcome back to one. I'm like, what the fuck is next?
The niece! The niece is the asshole!
Oh, wow. All right, so yeah, we're all working together. We've been four cats.
Are we?
We're all working together. We're a team. We've known
Pasta!
Each other like 12.
Parmesan is a cheese.
I just saw pasta.
No, sorry. We gotta take
pizza.
It
first. No, don't!
Have you guys heard that song that's like pizza, pasta, Pinot Grigio? Piss is so good that it gives you amnesia.
Go where you piss from.
Cheese, yeah.
It's cheese.
It's a cheese!
So what categories did we pick and why did cheese come up?
We didn't pick a single category.
Soccer.
Disney,
Star Wars, superheroes.
Why was there a cheese question?
Why is there an element?
Did it not remember the categories?
Which of these chemical elements is not a metal?
That's a science question.
Well, it's helium anyway. So
yeah, I guess we roll with it. But maybe like the
it
first
also
five.
Gives you like,
yeah,
like
it peppers
knowledge.
In general knowledge ones because general knowledge isn't a category, right?
It actually is.
Yeah.
Oh fuck me!
An octet is a musical composite. Do we just pause and see if the categories are working?
Ah, oh, fuck, we're in now.
Okay.
We're in now. Let's see how far we go.
I mean, it's eight. Yeah, okay.
Maybe just give me a Plastic Man question.
Complete the lyrics to the Rihanna song. That was quite a show. Very entertaining, but it's over now. Go on and...
Go on and...
take a bow? Eat some chow.
Show. Oh, my God.
Superhero is this about?
I think it might be take a bow. Like go on and take a
bow. I feel like take a bow is the most obvious one, but that also sometimes can mean that it's
I could
the
also
wrong
be wipe your brow thing. Though, couldn't it? Like go on.
It would be weird. Wipe
I know
your
very
brow?
Don't look at your phone.
I was gonna say, like, we can't look at the answer, but if we just play the song.
I don't know, I think it's either A or C.
Shall we use a lifeline?
It'll just be A or C, I bet you.
We could ask the audience.
Fuck it, let's go.
Ask the audience.
I
think it's take a bow, but
it's not going to be eat some chow, is it?
Good.
Obviously not.
Let's ask the audience.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, go for it, yeah.
All right. C, take a bow. Okay, C, final answer. Thank you, audience.
Oh, my God.
Fuji and Japan.
Japan!
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's Suzuki on my fucking Fuji. Slaps, by the way, as a race circuit.
Big fan.
Yeah. You got the X's at the beginning, and you go around, and you got the 130R. Oh, what a fucking...
What category is this?
Which of these is turned for a whole number? But it's not.
It's integer, right?
I think it's integer.
Well, we know it's not pi.
Yeah,
because it's not fraction.
It's not fraction. And I doubt it's quarter.
A quarter must be like a fourth.
Yeah,
because
it's like, oh yeah, he won by an integer. You know, it's like he won by a
nobody has
integer.
Ever fucking said that before.
He won,
lies, but yeah,
that he was won by a pi.
Fucking, oh, he won by fractions.
Fucking, that was just quoting.
That was something people would say.
Yeah, that's true.
I think you find I'm quoting. Someone very famous, Dr. Robert Oppenheimer, actually, when he judged the World Series.
Okay, I think it is integer.
I guess I'm right then. I guess I'm a fucking genius.
All right, integer final answer.
Now I am become commentator. Yes.
So, there's no categories.
Who did Ringo Starr replace as drummer of the Beatles?
I don't know this. The Beatles are like one of my favorite bands of all time, and I don't actually remember his name.
It cannot be Ginger Baker.
That's actually a superhero. Okay. That's actually why this is you.
Stuart Sutcliffe.
Could literally
be any of them.
Stuart Sutcliffe is a serial killer.
Is he?
Ian Stewart is a mouse. I think it's Pete Best. I actually think I might know.
No, Pete Best is the drummer for The Who. That would be the most insane career.
That'd be insane. Yeah, go from the Beatles to The Who.
I mean, he's the only one we know as a drummer.
I think we would be bigger news if The Who.
Do you remember when the drummer for The Who played the Beatles?
All right, 50-50.
Yeah. Also, if he's not the drummer for The Who, I'm going to look like a fucking idiot.
Now, we could use phone a friend, but if you'll remember, we do actually have to phone.
Yeah, I know who I'd phone.
Who would you phone?
I'd phone my dad.
You think he'd really know this?
Yeah, but he might say something that'll get us cancelled as well.
Let's go 50-50.
All right. We'll save Cam's dad and we'll go 50-50. I think it's Pete Best.
See, it's Stewart. It's got to be. And if it's not Pete Best,
okay, so
the more likelihood is that I'm wrong about him being the drummer for The Who, then if he is the drummer for The Who and he just happened to be in the Beatles and I didn't know that would be wild.
Look, I hate just trusting Cam on it, However, he's the only person to provide any sort of answer.
That's true. I have gone, I know that
you've
name.
You've just gone, it's Pete Best, let's go.
Is Pete Best a footballer?
No, that's George Best.
Okay, okay, yeah, so definitely.
And you're sure he's not the mouse?
Oh, maybe Keith Moon is the drummer for The Who.
How can you get so wrong?
There's a couple drummers. There's Keith Moon,
Pete Best, Ian Stewart.
Ringo Starr, sorry.
Me, I drummed for The Who. Oh, fuck, what if it is Pete Best? Keith Moon definitely was one of the drummers.
I say we flip a coin.
I say we go with Ian, and you guys just beat me with an inch of my life if I'm wrong.
Well,
I'm okay with that.
Any sort of weapons or
anything?
I got the Jack Daniel.
I'll grab the Master Sword. It's form, it's going to take a
my
lot.
My dad's going to be so mad at me.
Okay.
You should have just let me get myself cancelled.
Let's go for
Ian Stewart. Cam, if it is Pete Best, you are never going to hear the end of it.
I know.
Final answer?
Fuck, final answer. Why do I feel like...
I told you! I actually did think I knew that! It was in there somewhere!
Welcome back to One Run. Today I'm playing Super Mario 64. But if I die, the video ends. Count me down, Jack.
3, 2, 1, let's go!
Whoa, he spiced it up.
I think I already did that, though. I feel like I did. So, we've done Mario 64 a few times, but every time we've done it, it's been, if I get hit, the video ends, not die. But we're giving Cam a chance. Yes. We're just giving him a little chance.
How far can I get in this game I've played? Probably more than a lot of video games I've played.
I legitimately think you've played this game more than I have.
What? No way.
I think so, yeah.
You mean for a longer period of time, to be specific? Yeah. Because, like, I haven't played much of the game.
No, you...
Yeah. You put more hours in, you can't go further.
Because we sort of did a playthrough of it for Arcade Crowd, and I think I ended up with, like, 30 to 40 hours of footage, and I beat this game in a 3-hour stream. So even though I have 100% of this game multiple times, I still think you've played it more than I have.
Do you know what's weird? I'm struggling to get used to not having lag because we did this over COVID.
Oh yeah. Oh, remember COVID?
Remember? I spent all day every day playing Warzone. It was just the great. I relived my childhood for like
we played
18 months.
D&D 3 times a week. Oh, but that's where that joke came from. Oh, man. Bring back COVID.
Oh, my God.
Well, there's like a new strain of a new virus that's currently hitting the UK. So
I can't, boys. I just got a new job. I can't go back.
I go on furlough again.
I wouldn't mind a little lockdown.
Give me like a month.
A month. Can I just have a month?
Yeah,
that's all I want. I don't want to do 2 years. That was a lot.
Yeah, but, I just want to sit on my ass and be paid. That's all I want.
Yeah. Is that too much to ask?
Yeah.
Do you know what I want, actually?
Yeah, on the 6th, because there's the new Warzone update. So if I can just do that and like relive my childhood again.
I'm doing my birthday on the 7th. I'll give you the 8th. We'll have a pandemic on the 8th.
There we are.
Yeah? Okay.
Sorted.
Everybody clear your calendars. Yeah. Let's all just pretend.
Yeah.
We'll all just say we're not feeling well on the
8th. What are you going to do? Fire all of us?
Exactly. Workers of the world, unite.
Unite. We're going to unionize to have another COVID.
We want to play Warzone.
What a weird negotiation. Okay, you've all unionized, and what are your demands? COVID.
What
the fuck are you talking
more
about?
COVID.
More COVID.
More COVID.
Wait, you mean like more COVID protection? No, COVID. No.
Did I fucking stutter?
What's the punch button?
He's had about 40 hours in this game.
There you go, it's that. Okay. You got it.
Circle's a weird punch button, to be fair.
Is it?
Yeah, name another game the punch with circle.
Mario.
Your mum.
This is the game.
Yeah, you're right, Gav. You're right. I'm sorry. I was goofing on you, and I shouldn't have. I should have been more serious.
I'm trying to do my best here.
The thing is, I don't even care about the getting paid part. What I want, I just...
You should.
It was glorious.
Ship has sailed.
Anti-union worker. I don't care about being paid. I just want to have a deadly infection.
Where are you going?
It's not about the money. I just want people to die.
Yeah.
No, because, okay. Well, I still had to work during COVID, so that part wasn't that different for me. But what I want is to be able to open a group chat and go, hey, should we do this? And everyone going, yeah, all right.
Yeah, fine, yeah.
Yeah, sounds good. Yeah.
So do you want us to be a child again?
I guess. But I want to be a child where I know other people are suffering.
Wow.
Because I didn't know that as a child, you know?
Yeah, they were, but you just didn't know.
I didn't know. I don't want my innocence back. I just want to play Trouble in Terrorist Town. That's all I want.
It's tough. I mean, prioritizing playing video games with your friends is really hard in this day and age. You know?
Yes, it is, isn't it, Cameron?
It is. Wait, why are you looking at me?
Yeah.
Well, I alluded to it in another video. You'll be all right. This man is no threat. This was a very short notice recording. Okay. Because Cameron, knowing full well that we had these last 14 one runs, and like, yes, I don't expect you all to drop what you do with one run, but it's the last 14, so maybe, you know, pull your thumb out and make a fucking effort.
Okay.
Immediately squandered 2 free nights.
Okay,
immediately.
Hold on. I was in the chat, left, right, center, going, can you guys do this? Have you got your brought yet? Can you do this? And it just didn't work out. And then I had an opportunity to be like, oh, let me play some D&D with friends. But only some were free on one day and some were free on the other. And I was like, you know what? Let's try and get everyone in to play D&D just this week because Christmas is going to be crazy.
So not only are you squandering opportunities, you're doing stuff like that. You know I don't like to do it, so that I wouldn't be there.
No. That's not why I'm doing it. I'm doing it because there are people...
One night with Reese or 2 nights without Reese.
Yeah. Fucking hell.
Like, I love one run, but...
But, I mean, I have to see him.
Why did you quit?
I accidentally saved and quit.
He's done. He's out.
Can I get back in?
Yes, press start.
Oh, okay.
Stop playing with his face, you Mario D. Nice. Alright, well.
I was in the chat, I was in the trenches being like, can we do this? You guys know this, I never do it, but I was this time, because I wanted to get these days.
And then
days.
You got the glorious gift of 2 free days.
No, I have more than 2 free days.
How many days did you squander?
I was free Monday, I was free Friday, I was free Saturday.
Well, you know what you could have done, is put that in the one run chat first, and then Reese would have gone, oh, I'm free on Tuesday and Thursday, and then you'd have known.
But I didn't know, because here's the thing. Because I didn't know when Reese gets his rota. Because Reese
gets
his rota.
You're blaming me now.
No, it's not Reese's.
I have a bone to pick with you of that as well.
It's not Reese's fault. It's not Reese's fault. It's just Reese's work.
Okay. No, I take issue with that. I was going to bring it up. I'm glad you reminded me. How do you not know when he gets his rota?
Because it's fucking random.
No, it's not. It's been Wednesday forever.
No, it's not, though. Because Wednesday, he knows when he works some days, but not all days. And then... What is it? Thursday?
No, Wednesday's always been the road today.
It literally always has. Did you not wonder that I always ask when we're free on a Wednesday? Because I know that's when he gets his rota. We've been doing this for 2 years.
I feel like it's different. I feel like it's different. Because you... So you don't know...
It's his job and he's saying
but that, but that means that Reese doesn't know if he's working Thursday before Wednesday. Is that true?
No, I know when I'm working Thursday because that's the last day of the rota.
Wait, okay, so... Okay, so you get... On Wednesday, you get up until the next Thursday.
Yes.
Oh my god. Okay, I understand now. I apologize.
Several thousand times.
You know, I don't want to toot my own horn, Roos. Yeah. You didn't have to explain that to me. I picked up on the pattern.
Yeah, I noticed you asked every Wednesday. Yeah. So I knew.
Say what? I'm
not going to be judged.
Sherlock Holmes connecting the dots. Like, there's a pattern to all of this.
Here's the thing. The D&D thing was so fucking stressful because I was trying to organize something because no one could ever come to all sessions. So I was like, let me do this thing. Oh, I've got to go.
Why you got that?
No, I think that was right. Did you talk to the guy, though? Did you start racing the Cooper?
No.
Okay, well, go race him, but that's where you got to go.
Oh, shit. I didn't realize I'd lose health.
Oh.
So I was like fighting for my life, trying to get this D&D thing organized.
Fighting for my life.
I was! Oh, that gives me health back.
Yes, it always has! Okay, well now I know coins give me health back, but when did you get your rota? I think I'm going to miss this more than anything else.
I was so stressed trying to make sure that everyone...
Talk to the Cooper! Sorry, no, you know what, Cam? That was out of line. That was out of line. He's at the
Where's
start
the
of the
Cooper?
Course.
Okay.
Now fucking talk to him!
So I'm just trying to do it. I can't, like, be like, okay, yeah, and then also I have to make sure this and this and this and this. Like, I found a solution, and then I was like, this is the solution. Now let me figure out how we're going to do one run.
Okay, and the thing I'm mad about is that the first thought wasn't, let's figure out one run, the thing we've been trying to schedule, and is somewhat on a time limit.
Well, in my opinion, I
okay. I mean, that's you fair. Know, that's there's a reason we're ending it, so.
But the I'm just getting sick of arguing with you, honestly. It's like everything's a problem.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Am I the arsehole?
Jesus Christ. Well, you got me. Congratulations. You made me feel bad.
That makes me so happy.
Wow.
I'm glad we could I could finally do it like right before the channel dies. That's fantastic. Oh, eat my ass, Cam.
Jesus. See, I never participated in this because I have fun with it and then you go overboard.
Oh, wait, I'm supposed to be the rest of the group.
Ooh, look at this. So I think you'll be able to go to a different course after getting this star. Or you might only need one.
Should I try and get... I never got the red coins on this course.
I don't think you got the red coins on any course.
I think I got it on the ice course because I remember trying real hard.
You put his big boy pants on and he did it.
Now you gotta wait for him to catch
him. Oh, really?
Yeah. Sorry, he's only there.
Damn it. I just thought I'd lost. When nothing happened, I was like, okay, I'm lost.
There you go.
Ugh.
Jesus
Christ. Close to me.
I just licked the pop filter doing that.
Why are you on the ball? There you go. Got it.
All right, let's shift gears.
Okay.
Yeah, let's calm down.
We'll stop collectively going too far.
Reese has...
I mean, that's... Continue, don't save is fine. Save and continue is fine. One you don't want has the word quit in it.
At least Reese has a reason to be mad.
What do you mean I have a reason to be mad?
You don't have a reason
to be
mad.
You've
seen my life. Jesus.
Go to that door.
Oh, I could have gone through this immediately. I guess it's an easy star to get, though, the race and the Koopa.
Yeah, yeah. And I mean, you're going for 120 stars, right? So yeah, it's important to get them all now. You know.
Could you even do 120 stars without Diane?
Oh, fuck, probably not, no. Honestly, dude, it would be like three courses that would be the issue with that.
Oh,
like,
really?
There's a lot that are very easy to not die on, but like, I mean...
Oh, it's Cam's favorite course.
Yeah. For you, this is one of those courses.
I hate this so much. Do you think it would be easier with a Nintendo 64 controller?
I doubt it.
Sometimes I feel like because they've adapted. You know the N64, it had like notches.
Yeah.
So you can go in, it would like lock in certain directions. Is the game compensating for the fact that I can go in all directions, or is it kind of locked?
I honestly don't know an answer to that. What I do know is the notches on the N64 controllers aren't accurate.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like if you hold it in the forward notch, it's slightly to the right.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Because Nintendo just didn't give a fuck about that controller. It's so strange. Have you guys ever held a proper N64 controller?
Yeah, I went to a con once and they had like a set up spin GoldenEye.
You're good.
You're fine.
I just made a certain demographic of our audience feel very old by asking that question.
Which demographic? I feel like we don't get people like older than us watching our videos.
Because there aren't many people older than us, can't
yeah,
that's true. That, on the internet. I was playing well.
Well, that's not true because I make this mistake all the time. I always think that like we are older than we are because I feel
I don't know
like my body failing, but it's not.
Remember that old COVID thing that I want to get back, but really don't know how old I feel.
I think it's like because I haven't taken care of my body. Yeah. I think I'm older than I am.
I saw recently for the first. Don't know, every year there's like the thing of like people who were born in 1991, you know, 30's coming up.
Mm,
yeah. Like, I keep laughing. I'm like, oh yeah. But I saw yesterday a 1994 one. And I was like, oh no.
Oh fuck.
Are you guys afraid of 30? I've never really.
I'm just afraid of like dying, Cam, to be honest.
Well, that's fair, but I don't think you die when you're 30. I think
you're close though.
Yeah. Significantly closer than when I was when I was 20.
Wait, I'm actually.
What's the age people usually die? Is like 75? Is like they're. The normal, so
like the average, yeah.
The average, yeah. So you're almost halfway.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Thank Christ. Fuck.
This there is yeah, and that's why people are when they see 30 of it, like, ooh.
No, I don't know, man. I feel like I'm ready to be 30. Like at the end of this year, I was
ready
like,
for death.
Oh, guys, it's gonna be fun. Everyone always says
it's gonna be great.
Everyone always says the 30s is the most fun.
Yeah,
and
that's
like
true.
Everyone I know who's 30, it like seems like they're having a whale of a time.
Yeah, because they're living out their last years.
Yeah, they're making the most of it.
They gotta do what they can, you know?
Okay, this is the episode where you guys just piss everyone off, including me.
I once, do you know, Tick Tick Boom, the...
The musical.
The musical, yeah. And then the movie came out based on it. I sent my friend that first song, the 1390.
Yeah.
And he's like, he was born like a couple of months before me, so he turns 30 before me, and he had a proper like full on crisis.
Jokes aside, I am sort of with you. I feel like 30 is going to be good, but to be fair, I said that about 28.
You see,
why would you say that about 28 though?
I just had
I feel
a good
like
feeling.
That's such a random age.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I know that time doesn't really
exist
in the way that we measure it, but even so, 28 is not like a standout number.
Let me explain this once you can. It just happens to be the age I am.
Oh, okay.
That was the joke I was going
like,
for.
I just needed it to be good.
Life begins at 28. That's what they say, right?
Right?
Right? Right? Right, guys?
Oh, what was my strategy with this guy? I remember I could get under
the
legs.
Yeah, he jumps under you. Right. He jumps under you.
There you go.
And he up, and then stomp him. Nope, not quite.
Do you know what's really strange about this game? I haven't really thought of it.
What the fuck?
This is like one of three mini bosses, I think. I can't think of another one. And they put the first two in the first two levels.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Mm. And it like would paint an expectation that every level would have a mini boss. But they really don't.
Can you tell him what to do here?
Just figure it out a ground pound, Gab. That's all you got to do. I feel like you got all the pieces.
Just give him the button.
I think it's one of the triggers. There you go.
There we are.
Oh, I didn't realize they were an option.
Back in those days, they didn't have the triggers.
Oh,
almost.
Fuck me.
Nope, here we go again.
This guy's easy. I'm just dumb.
Bonk. Hey, that's nice. One.
Yeah, I was playing WoW, just like chatting to people, and somebody just brought, like, I can't remember how it came up, but I basically said in chat, like, God, remember Rage Comics?
Mm.
And there were so many people in that chat that were like, the fuck are Rage Comics? And it made me realize just how stupid they are, because how do you describe it? It's like, imagine a comic, but it's bad. And that was the appeal.
There's got to be like an equivalent now that you could compare it to.
Wow, TikTok?
Yeah, but like, it would be a specific TikTok, right? Like, it would be like, God, I don't know. Like, yeah, Rage Comics are so weird. Like, I want to say that, like, there's that type of human now, but maybe there isn't. Maybe we just evolved past that.
Again, because I'm...
We got Winton instead.
I suppose that kind of humor is what that evolved into, right? Because, like, Rage Comics were very lol random.
Well, no, because some of the good ones were lol random, but, like, the worst Rage Comics, I feel like, and the most prevalent ones were, like just like angry at someone.
Well, that's
you know?
Where the name comes from, right?
Yeah, but it would be like angry at someone
He's
for like
learning.
No, not really. A good reason. You know, like why you know something, or like a lot of them were like
why you know something. You know?
All right, granddad.
But don't you remember like a lot of them were like you know just like angry at like I don't know girl gamers and stupid shit like that. You know,
the thing is, I genuinely do not remember the appeal of them. Like, there's a lot of things I was into when I was younger that I think are stupid now, but, like, I can understand why 12-year-old me likes them. But I legitimately think the appeal was just, oh my god, it's content on the internet.
Yeah.
I legitimately think that's what it was. Like, if you go back and watch some of the, like, really old Newgrounds animations, there's nothing in them. They're, like, completely vapid. There's no joke. It's just, oh my god, I can click this button and a cartoon plays.
Yeah.
Fucking aneurysm of this current.
Okay, maybe I should do something different. Should I do Owless?
Jump off that thing.
You could do Owless, but it's not the star.
Should I just do Owl? Owlful?
Yeah, I do Owlful. No Owl. There's no Owl cam.
Oh?
You're not on the star that has the Owl.
Oh.
So there's no Owl.
No Owl.
Oh my god. Again.
What?
You just can't let this one go.
Can't like Waco.
That piranha plant. I saw you giving him evils. You were thinking about it.
It's not worth it, mate.
Yeah, just let it go, Cameron. He's not a threat.
Look, we've all had a lot to drink tonight, right?
Can I do something with this box?
You can do something with it. I don't know if you can do anything useful with it. Leave him alone! Mate, I'm sorry. He's...
fucking killed him. A blue.
It's like the end of the character arc. I don't know if you guys even remember it at this point, but when we did this game for Arcade Crowd, there's a funny clip of you getting killed by that piranha.
Oh, really?
And there's just no reason for you to fight him at all.
I thought he might have something cool.
Well, I guess he did.
He did have a blue thing. Couldn't I get up here?
Yeah, you can. Okay.
Like the big jump.
I know big jump, like long big
There's
jump.
Also the turny jump. Oh, your fucking nemesis is back. If you're running in a direction and you flick the other direction and jump, you'll do a turn jump. Yeah, and that'll if you do that the other way, it'll get
Oh, I see, okay.
Yeah. Don't know why Mario turning on the spot gives him a higher jump, but it is.
I mean, like, it's a blessing for watching cool speedruns, though.
That is true.
Yeah. I think the
Is that what you're doing right now? Is that a cool speedrun? No.
The reason this game is so fun to watch for speedruns is because how janky it is. Like, it's extra impressive. Like, a more intuitive game would be less impressive to master, you know?
It is sort of insane. Oh my god, dude, I will fucking slap your face.
Please don't, I have to think.
Oh my god.
Cam, I did warn you.
I'll slap a tooth right out your fucking mouth.
Please do. That's what I need, but the dentist will tell me. Will help me.
The dentist.
That's some rage comic humor.
Le dentist.
Why you no take tooth out of face?
Go to donk test. Donk test won't take tooth out. Why you no take tooth? It would rage.
I'm gonna have to make that now.
It is leh. Where did the leh come rage. From?
Yeah, leh. Oh, it was all about lehs and tehs, Cam. Remember teh?
I don't remember teh.
I'm gonna go to.
Oh yeah, like
T-E-H.
Like futalols.
Yeah. Oh, I used to do so much things futalols.
Yeah.
And I now look at me. I have so to pay funny. Tax.
Oh.
Oh fuck, I do have to do my tax. What date is it?
It's not till the end of January, you're fine.
Yeah, I know, but take it from me, a man who does his tax in January every single fucking year. Don't do your tax in fucking January single fucking year.
Yeah, it's rough.
It's the worst.
I guess I'm just going up here.
Yeah, I mean,
or even
I love my life is a circle. And I feel like I will say the sentence to you again and again and again.
Yeah.
The name of the star gives you a clue.
Oh, God. I remember you saying that, but I don't remember the answer. What are you laughing at?
I don't know what else to do.
What are you laughing at?
I don't know the answer.
What are you laughing at? Oh, top of the forest, there you go.
Fortress.
Ow! 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 I'm so legitimately worried about you, Cap. It, like... Because you are this...
This is you.
This is you. This is me.
Oh, hey, oh.
When a turn of turns gonna do me better.
What the fuck is that? It's like the sim version.
Oh my god, you guys gotta pause for like 10 seconds and let me inhale.
No.
we go again.
We ride.
Fuck me.
Wait, what was the first joke?
This is who you are.
The first joke.
Like, I you know, we're on mic, so you know, we're having fun, we're having a good time, but I need you all to understand, this is what he's like.
This is me.
Look out, because here Cam comes.
You do pop, do pop, da da da. My simlish is really bad. Have you seen the videos of, like, Katy Perry singing in Simlish? It's so strange. Like, she's a very accomplished pop star. Do you think she, like, regrets doing that?
No, I think she has fun. I think it's fun for people. I mean, the fact that, like, the Black Eyed Peas did it before, I'd be like, yeah, I'll do Simlish. If the Black Eyed Peas did it, and they got a whole game out of it.
Did they?
Yeah, The Sims, The Herbs. Do you ever play The Sims, The Herbs?
I did. I didn't know that had anything to do with Black Eyed Peas.
Really?
Yeah.
You don't remember? Let's scoop ba ba ra ba ba, su ra ba bu ru wa ba. I mean, like, he, Will.i.am comes and meets you at the beginning of the game. He's okay. Like the...
I didn't remember that.
I mean, I haven't played it, but
Me and Reese, like, way back in the day had, like, a co-op
game. Oh, fuck, yeah, I forgot about that.
We got really mad because on two-player, they don't give you a bigger apartment. It was, like, too small. Yeah. And we were like, I want this part.
I was
house.
A successful pop star at that point as well, so I deserve a mansion.
Yeah, and the closest thing I contributed was kicking over bikes outside of a club. It was really cool, though, that game.
We have like quite a few more games to do, and that, like, about a minute and a half ago I saw stars.
Okay.
And
well, speaking of stars, let's do Owlers.
Use the information. Oh my god, is that all it took?
There it is.
Is that was that the keyword that like fucking activated him like a sleeper agent?
The answer.
I'm about to get hit by a bullet bill.
You are. Oh, I wish this was a no-hit run. Okay. Whoa!
I'm John Wick.
I have activated him. I've turned him on. I shouldn't have said it like that.
Turned him on.
Why is everybody's fake cum? Like,
sorry, what?
Why is everybody fake?
Why is everybody fake cum around here?
Yeah. Someone tell me. What do I do to make it real?
What I gotta do to make it cum?
Don't you dare. Don't.
Go on. For all the marbles. Aim for the bushes.
Another star!
Go to a different course.
What I gotta do to make you come?
What I was gonna say is, why is it when anybody ever does an impression of somebody coming, it's like they've never heard someone come before in their life? Like,
I don't know, Jack, why is that?
I just like, why is everybody...
There's gotta be a reason, guys.
Why is everybody like... Aah! Has anybody ever sounded like that while coming?
All right, listen, I'll be honest. I've only ever watched Viking porn.
Besides the point.
I think it's just funny. It's just funny, you know? It's just funny. It's funny. A little bit of hoo-ha, a little jokey joke.
A little hee-hee.
A little hee-hee.
Nah, it just has to be fact to me, you know?
Yeah.
Your facts don't respect my feelings or whatever the fuck he says.
Ooh.
I think that's the complete opposite thing.
That's a really honest conservative.
Actually, your facts really upset me. So
that was actually Ken Byro said that one.
He's just gone the water and fucking face first.
If anybody understood my Ken Byro joke, I would really like you to let me know.
I don't know what that means.
It was a pretty deep cut, but if there's somebody out there who gets it, let me know. And then I'll feel good about myself. But
is that just a like Ryan Gosling on a pen?
Oh, it's like that movie.
It's like a Ken Pest Drive. Dispenser. Yeah. You see other people go to the Barbie yelling, "I drive."
What are you doing, Cam? You're having a nice swim.
I was
time.
Looking for stars.
Time. You know?
Looking for stars.
They're not going to be bobbing about in the ocean,
but they might be on one of these islands.
Well, maybe. Nice.
Almost. Yeah, getting that.
There you go. You have a bit of a grace period after the animation starts to do this bit.
Can't you just jump it?
I mean, technically yes. Can Cameron do it?
Yeah, fair.
Okay, nice.
Go for a cap.
What I gotta do to make you come?
God, it is like you're bringing back just a little bit of COVID. Just a little bit of that feeling.
Every little thing I do is magic. Where's the doc?
Right. Are you going for red coins?
No.
Then why are you doing that course?
We've had the exact conversation. I just had a flashback to the fucking live streams where you were like, why are you going for the red coins?
Oh, there's stars under
these?
There
was something familiar about that sentence, yeah.
There's stars under these?
No, you got red coins.
Oh, fuck me. There's red coins everywhere.
Okay, let me ask you something, Cam. Are you going for the red coins?
Going for the stars.
Nice. Pick that up. Pick that up. Pick that up.
Okay.
Pick it up. Pick it up. Pick it up. Nice.
Is it done now?
Cam, get up now.
Oh, Swim up, air. No, don't what just drown. Don't just fucking drown. After all that, dude, if you just drown.
Where am I going?
Not that way.
That's back at this fucking start.
Okay.
What a circle.
Do you need big clam in the back? Cam, just fucking leave it.
No. He said to pick it up.
Cam, please leave it. Cam.
Okay, forget the shell. Okay. I'm sorry, it was my fault. I made a mistake.
So where am I going?
Just that way. Just that way for a bit, and then down. I'll be honest, this course kind of sucks.
Okay.
It's very small, and it's mostly just water. All right, go down from here.
It's so nice, though. It sounds so nice.
The music is quite loud. Peaceful. Let me get rid of that.
Oh.
Down.
Oh, like okay. Proper down.
Yeah.
I'm going down, down.
What does the rest of the song go like?
Sugar, we're going down, spirit.
Spirit.
Swinging. Sorry, I remembered. I got a number one on the bonnet. something. Now you shake it and cock it. I can't remember. I can't remember.
Yeah, that much was clear. It.
Oh, Jesus! Have you played Super Mario Wonder yet?
No, it's my Christmas game.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. I'm not allowed to buy any new games for a bit. I need to get through my backlog.
That makes sense. Yeah. You got a big backlog.
Thanks, man. I'm glad you noticed. I tried Starfield again.
Oh, did you try it?
Yeah, if you go in trying to find the fun, it's there.
Oh, okay.
That's the nicest thing I can say about it.
One, two, three.
Quite impressed with that, Cam.
What?
Yeah. I mean, you only identified one as being electrified and then got the order right after that. It's pretty good.
Oh, it's electrified? I was just going towards boxes.
The first box electrified you.
Did it?
He's not joking.
I'm going down, skipping it in me.
It's real. I just need someone to believe me.
Believe what you like. I know myself. Bowser?
You need a couple more stars and then you can fight Bowser. Go through that door. Go through that door so we can get the fuck out of this video.
Why? This is going to be hard.
No, it's really easy. Really easy.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Why would we get the fuck out of
because you'll get all the rest. The other 115 stars are in this course.
Got out, nerd. Got out.
Pranked again. He's so pranked.
He's so pranked.
Jesus.
You can't go through that way. You should go back outside.
Yeah, it's actually the big portrait of Peach on the front of the castle. You gotta jump through that.
Come on, man. You've played this game. Am I the asshole for lying to my friend? the one on the right. That one.
So one on the right.
On the right
he has never played this game before.
There we are. Oh.
He's done this so many times.
Oh, here we go. Got that camera in?
All right. No, that's the next game.
Oh shit, okay.
We're good, he's fine. Alright, so
take it. Be cool.
Nice, be cool. Nice,
I'm the fucking best at Mario Kart. No one could beat me. I'm the fucking best Mario Kart around. Yow! Wait, what's the jump button?
You don't need it, you're fine.
But also, what the fuck do you mean? What's the jump button?
I thought it might be different.
Was that a serious question?
I thought about maybe like it might be different. Should I go to the basement?
No, go through the three door.
Three door. My favorite Star Wars character.
I'm glad this channel's ending. I need some space. My God.
Man,
slip sliding away, Cam. It's called Slip Sliding Away.
Hell yeah. I remember the little penguin boy.
Oh, he is?
Not time for him yet.
I mean, it could have been.
It's time.
All right,
for
so
Mario Kart 2.
Let it go.
Come on.
Taking it too nice.
I'm the best motherfucking Mario Kart, and I know how to jump.
Hey, he's done it.
When's that single come out?
Oh, I'm not chasing anyone right now, so that's probably why it's so easy.
I would have gone like, yeah.
It's a mistake right
now. Oh, you didn't use the secret exit.
Nope. And you fucking probably...
Oh my god, he's done it!
I'm the best motherfucking Mario Kart driver.
Try that.
I cannot... Maybe I should...
Now I need the jump button.
You're fine.
Yeah. All right, sure.
Wait for it.
Maybe.
Wait for it.
Why?
Oh, I don't. Ooh. I was wrong.
Are a fucking... bafflement to me.
I'm a bafflement.
You're it, like,
is that okay to say in 2023?
Well, I I'll be honest, I subbed that for a different word.
Okay.
How
I died last time. I jumped for the star.
Yeah. Careful. And up.
We have seen in this video, which by the way is approaching 40 minutes, that
this is the end of one run. It's the end.
I was gonna go with Skyfall, but I'm gonna...
Oh, let the one run.
Yeah.
That was a joke, Iris.
Yeah.
It was going to be just on par with
that.
Yeah,
you got me.
We have seen in this video that Cam, there's something wrong with his brain. There is. He doesn't want to admit it. His wife doesn't want to admit it, but there's something wrong with his brain. He can't remember anything about anything. It doesn't matter how many times he does it, but for some reason he remembers slides. Because this one and the last one, you were like, yeah, I know this, I've got this. You remember the shortcut? You remember that there was...
No,
the
I remember the shortcut because you said, oh, you didn't do that. And I remembered that.
You didn't have the shortcut. That's fair enough. But you were able to extrapolate from that there was a shortcut when maybe 3 minutes ago you asked me what the fucking jump button was.
I thought it might be different because I was sliding.
Why? Oh. What a terrible game design decision that would be.
I know, but like... What are you going to do? It's the 90s.
What are you going to do, yeah?
You know what? He's right. What am I going to do?
Wait, was it the 90s?
Yeah. 97?
7?
97, 98, I think. Depending on region.
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus.
Cam, you can do this. All right?
I can do this. I did this before.
Yeah. These guys didn't end the one run when it was hit.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow, I'm so good.
You are? Yeah, dude, you're amazing. You just waddle on down there and you deliver that penguin.
Down there. What's this guy? I forgot about this guy. Go away. You're gross, I don't like you.
Wow.
This takes me back to school. When I was a bully. Nice. Yeah, like, he remembered which penguin it was as well. Is it just this course?
There's only one penguin.
Yeah, there's only one big penguin, isn't
there? There's one bit. No, I meant you remembered which penguin to bring to the big penguin. But I think what he was saying is that there's only one little penguin.
Yeah, there is.
There's plenty.
Really?
Yes.
How do I raise Big Penguin?
If you go back in, I think it is actually the next star, but you also could go fight Bowser.
Me want to race Big Penguin.
Me
oh, want Big Penguin race, there we are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we're not going to fight Bowser this
one. No, this is good because I'm good at slides. And if I lose to Big Penguin, it doesn't mean I die.
True, but...
Let's go!
Oh. All right, Cam.
Okay, now I have to really
gentle with it on this one.
I really have to do the shortcut, right?
Because you don't get the star with the shortcut.
Is that true?
Big Penguin calls you a big cheater and you don't get the star.
Oh, fuck. All right, let's do it, Big Penguin.
It would be incredible for you to make it a Bowser. I'm just saying. That would be great for the channel. For the video. If you could just why jump?
Stop jump.
Oh, does jump slow down?
Jump does slow down. No jump. Jump bad. No jump.
Oh, yeah, come on, lead, Big Penguin. Come on, Big Penguin.
All right. Now.
Get in the middle.
You can also just jump that gap if you need to. Hey, look at that.
Oh, done.
All right. Get that star off that Big Penguin and go fight Bowser. You've already won.
I thought punching was the interact button. Wait. It's not the same star.
No, you have to talk.
Talk to
Penguin.
No,
but in the house. I think you just lost Penguin? I think you're going to have to do it again. Wait. Maybe go back in. I don't think it will remember. I can't even
go back in.
Oh, fuck me.
I will give you credit that is just bad design. Like, Because most players are going to be like, I won, I'll leave.
Because I thought I was trying to interact with him, yeah. But it didn't work.
I'll give you a pass on this. You have to wait until she stops moving, and then you can talk to her.
I see. Okay, me and you, Big Pan, win round 2.
I was so happy that he got through it. I was like, oh wow, we might actually see a Bowser fight. Isn't that incredible?
Maybe not this time.
Yeah. Well, you can only get so lucky. This one, you know?
Oh yeah, nice.
I can. I'm the greatest Mario Kart player of all time.
Not to jump.
Jack just hung up on someone.
I'm sorry. We're recording.
He was a viewer that called.
Yeah, be careful. These ones out.
If it goes again, I'll answer it.
Oh God.
That's fine. It's fine.
You're good.
Nice and smooth.
Smooth. This is a lot easier without the lag.
Which is funny because you were adamant that wouldn't be the case when you were playing.
Yeah, well, I was super confident.
Right, wait.
Hey, Big Penguin.
Like, you dodged the penguin. All right, just wait, and then you can talk, and then...
Give me the star, Big Penguin.
There we go.
Hey.
It is weird.
I mean, it's from 1960, whatever. What are you going to do?
You're right, Gav. I didn't think about it. I didn't consider it.
Bowser time, baby!
It's gone better, if I'm being honest.
Yeah.
Yeah. She just quit. Hold on.
It's still technically an improvement.
Did I save?
I don't think you can quit without saving. Press start.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you're fine.
All right, get in there, fight Bowser, get me out of here, and I can make that phone call.
Let's hope it wasn't important.
If it was important, I think it would have gone again.
Yeah, that's true.
Hello, this is the president of the Earth.
They've given me one phone call.
Ooh, the aliens that arrested him. What are you talking about?
And you're the only man who can help. I don't know why the president sounds like this.
Oh, it's me. The president of the Earth.
Guys, it's the president.
It's definitely just the aliens. Hello. We need your nuclear launch codes.
This is I, president of Earth. I forgot my password to the loot.
Oh, God.
Oof.
What was that?
Did a legitimate oof.
You're fine.
You're good, Cam. You're good. Just relax.
Yeah.
It's only Bowser.
Dude, I'm so relaxed.
Almost
I'm
too
so relaxed.
Mm.
I'm so ready to say goodbye to gay Bowser.
Hell yeah.
You actually say so long.
Oh, it is so long.
Yeah.
In my head, I had Mandela affected it to be goodbye, Gay Bowser.
Well, that's less Mandela affecting than fucking Charles Martin A did.
I really don't think you should blame him. It's like, you don't know what the compression did to that guy.
That level of compression, it does things to a guy.
They compressed him. How do you think he got it so small and get him in the video game?
Mario was meant to be a giant, actually.
Hey.
What I'm talking about there, I feel like I've talked about it in a Mario video, but that Salon Gay Bowser thing, Charles Martinet was asked about it, which is very funny, because I like the idea of, like, 70-year-old Charles Martinet being asked, so when you said Salon Gay Bowser, what were you actually saying? And he said, so long, King Bowser.
Yeah, which I can totally see the compression destroying.
I think he's full of shit and he's hiding something.
What do you mean he's hiding something?
I think he knows about Bowser's being gay. And he's not ready to out his friend.
He's like, I think you're gonna go so much weirder than that. Yeah. I think you're gonna be like, I think
what I said was pretty weird.
I think it's the gay agenda. You suddenly become super right wing.
Think Mario's turning kids gay.
In 1963, when this game came out,
I played Mario replaced Ringo Starr. As
Yeah, it'd be great if it was like fucking Rob Best or whatever his name was. Stuart Little and Super Mario. Which one of these drummed for the Beatles?
Which one of these are gay? According to Charles Martinet. Do I just...
Bowser, he looks like...
Fuck me. So stupid.
What? The texture isn't being upskilled very well on Bowser. It looks like...
So long.
He said it!
Hey.
Nah.
Oh.
Almost.
Oh, yeah, if he falls off, it doesn't count.
I implore you.
Yeah?
Don't beat Bowser.
Why not?
Oh, no, you're right. You do you, Gab. You do you.
Ooh, you
so long.
Oops.
It really gets me that I can't attack and run at the same time.
Defend.
Shit.
He's teasing him.
So long.
At a mine.
I'm trying.
Shit. Oh!
Here we go! So long.
So long.
So long, Street Mario.
Finally. Come on, Cam.
Oh, he's juked you.
Do it for Wales.
He's broken your fucking ankles.
Oh,
shit.
At a mine.
Okay.
You can spin him for as long as you like. You don't have to rush it.
Really?
Yeah, there's no time limit. You got him by the tail, Cam. You can't do jack shit.
Oh, I guess I watch too many speed runs where they really rush it.
Yeah, this isn't a speed run. I need to stress that. Okay, technically incredible.
That's all I needed a year, baby.
You took such a chance that he couldn't do damage to you while he was upside down.
Well, I grab him again. I think I had to do it a couple times.
It is insane. How are we here?
I don't get it.
I'm the best around. No one's gonna ever get me down. I keep almost quitting. My Wait, am I supposed to go through Bowser?
No.
Okay.
No, it's a little tricksy, Cam. If you look back, or just fucking leave.
It's Peach.
Yeah. All right. Fair enough.
Key doesn't fit.
No, it doesn't fit in that, Cam.
Shit.
I can't believe we're still here.
I know. I thought I'd be done by then.
We'd be all right, because for the first time and the last time in one run history, we do not have an end time.
Yeah.
Which is nice.
However, a couple of the videos are going to come out later. Will take quite a long time to record.
Yeah, when we were planning this, we did sort of, went for a little dip and that's
Is that out there?
You're right, Cam. You're right. Just go to the basement.
No, you got it, Cam.
I'm not going to argue with you. We did kind of backload the games we thought would take longer just to have a bit of time to have a chat and a bit of a reminisce about the channel.
That's not happening.
Yeah.
Well, maybe it'll be the opposite. Maybe we'll play Eldum. Oh, we don't want to spoil the games.
That's fine.
We'll play a long game and
by
FromSoft short time.
Elden Ring is going to be long. There's no way.
So?
Yeah, dude. I really don't think
that was the one we planned to talk in. Yeah.
The only, fuck it. We're 40 minutes in. The only thing, nearly 50. Good. Okay, we're out. We're in. It's happening, boys.
This is the one you guys made fun of me in front of my wife.
Yeah, we did. And I don't think that gives her enough credit because your wife also made fun of you for.
My wife.
My wife. My favorite moment. We're talking about a stream we did. I can't remember what we did it for, but Jen joined us to play this for Arcade Cred. And you did basically that. And she's like, Why are you doing that? Why are you jumping? What are you jumping for? And me and Risa are just dead behind the eyes.
Oh!
I mean...
Oh, he got lucky because he was thrown straight into coins.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got that right, boss.
Doesn't this texture look like a placeholder?
Cam, a lot of this game looks like a placeholder. They were doing what they could, right? It was the 1800s. Any idea what you're doing?
I'm trying to get to Big Boy. Is he here?
I mean, you are trying to...
Stop it! All evening, you've been just moaning.
You just saw Big Boy.
Big Boy.
Get out, Cam. Get some coins in you.
Get some coins in you, son.
I'm really worried about Elden Ring. I'm so worried about Elden Ring.
Why are you worried about Elden Ring?
We talked about it like a minute ago!
You know, he's using all his brains.
No, hold on. You said it was going to take too long. Right?
Right.
But I was almost dying, and then you said, I'm really worried about Elden Ring. Surely me dying would be good for Elden Ring.
Right, but it has still been 50 minutes. You dying now doesn't undo that. Although...
Welcome back to One Run. Today I'm playing Mega Man, but if I complain about Mega Man, the video ends. Count me down, Jack.
3, 2, 1, go. Had absolutely no idea if that was you practicing the intro or doing the intro.
No.
He's trying to stay calm.
I'm being somber.
So,
and I want my run to have an impact, so I will be Impact Man.
You're going to be Impact Man.
I will embody the Impact Man.
So just a little background.
Well, here's the thing. I think you're about to explain the premise, and before you do, I just want to say that I think this is a terrible idea.
Oh, okay. I think this is a great idea.
I love this idea.
Reese,
Are those electric? Who knows?
Has historically like not enjoyed Hitman games.
Shoot them.
So we're gonna see how long he can play Hitman. He can die as many times as he wants.
It's not Hitman. I thought you said Hitman.
Mega Man. Sorry.
If he complains about Cam, that's fine. The video's not going.
Oh my god.
Without
the Underminer.
If he complains once, he dies.
No.
We're gonna kill Reese.
A gun pointed directly at my head. If I say anything mean about Megs over here, me and Megs we're on first name turns out.
No, here's the thing.
Oh, can I go? I assume I can go down it. Oh, I assume right.
Nice.
I gotta wait for this bird to drop.
This was the only way.
Oh my word! I love that. I love it. I love it so much.
Do you think you know how?
Oh no!
It's okay.
It's fine.
It's fine.
I can die all I want.
Yeah, which means you can keep replaying this same level again and again.
Yeah,
and
it's
again.
Like it's like live, die, repeat. You know? Yeah. I know exactly what I'm up to now. Yeah. Good shout. There we are.
We should give a little background. We swore to never play Mega Man on this channel again so Reese wouldn't kill us. And not in like a complains he dies, but in like a real way.
Yeah. It look, Mega Man's great. It for a one run, it is one of the most frustrating things you can ever do to yourself.
What are you talking about? It's the best.
That's actually a good technique to try and catch him out. It's like all
this rocket gun.
Yeah.
And try to get Reese in on it, you know?
We have given Mega Man the best chance it can
help
have.
Help me, Mega Man! Help me, Mega Man!
Because I feel like Mega Man 11 is the least bullshit one. And obviously, you know, we played Mega Man 11 first, and then we played every other Mega Man between that and worked our way back.
100% all of them.
Yeah.
Even the ones with a 3D.
And obviously, it's such a shame we lost all the footage, but we did.
What if we played the 3D ones and Reese was like, this is actually the best game I've ever played.
Channel's
in
ending in about 7 days, Cam, so I don't think we're going
to. Yeah, we'll be fine. Right.
We'll be fine.
Oh, he's speeding up.
Now, you do have the double gear system.
I don't know how it is. You skipped the tutorial.
I did. I think it's the bumpers or the triggers. One of them makes you do more damage, and the other one slows down time.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And they both use the same bar.
Bumper.
That's the slow boy. Yep.
Oh, I fucked up.
He nice. Played about himself.
Good use of my time. Good use of my time. Oh, I've done it again.
Does this feel like a particularly frustrating screen, Reese?
No, it's fine. I just gotta adapt, overcome.
Yeah. I've mentioned it in a previous video that us doing these last 14, while they were planned well in advance, the actual us filming today was pretty short notice because Cam's a fuck. What I considered, and I don't think we would have done it, so don't feel like you're missing out, but I thought we could have hooked Reese up to a heart rate monitor.
Oh, nice.
And
yeah.
If his heart.
I don't need to know how fast my heart is. Not just from Mega Man, I just don't need to know that. That information.
If Reese finds out his BPI,
out I have high blood pressure, the video ends.
I put on. I don't know if I'm so embarrassed. I don't know if I want to share this. I bought a smartwatch right when COVID kicked off, so about 3 years ago. But I haven't really worn it for like a year and a half, maybe. I don't know. Just stopped wearing it. I realized I didn't really like wearing a watch. I put it on for the first time about a week ago, and it warned me. I got a warning on my phone being like, you have a very high resting heart rate. Like, you need to do something now or you are going to die.
Wow, Reese, this looks really fun.
It is. It's great. I don't know what you're getting at. Yeah, you know,
why are you being so negative? Mega Man's awesome. It's beloved.
I didn't want to interrupt you, Jack, but one of my favorite moments in all of One Run just happened where Reese was like, you have to observe, adapt, change. And he was just getting beaten the fuck out of relentlessly.
Improvise, overcome. If I go now, he goes speedy that direction, so I have time. See? I know Mega Man. Mega Man knows me. He's my friend.
Getting hit by rockets on both sides.
I know Mega Man. He's my friend.
You wouldn't lead me astray. Ready? Go! Live, die, repeat.
Can you imagine it? Because we know where this is going. We know what's going to happen. But what if he just ends up finding
inner peace?
Yeah.
Reese becomes a Buddhist, so the video ends.
Mega Man 11, but if I change religion, the video ends.
If I see God.
If I find Nirvana.
So, Nirvana? Smells like Teen Spirit over here. I went straight for it. Yes!
Wow.
And again.
Forcing him not to complain makes him worse at comedy.
I love Mega Man. I've got to continue.
Oh, God.
You can't.
Laura Bunkins.
Mega Man
is super cool. He is my friend.
I love that his technique is not so I not to complain, to become friends with Mega Man.
Good old man. He loves
men.
Me too. Oh, no.
Oof, that was close. He was like,
I have a question. Since we're in like the back half of the last 14 now, what is your guy? What's your guy's biggest regret? But specifically with One Run.
Oh, okay. Well, like, is there the same answer? It's you.
Why would you do
that? Yeah, the feeling's mutual, Cam.
I pulled the mic stand out. He just fucking tanks this fall every single time.
No!
Sorry, what? No, but what?
I know that myself. I didn't.
Oh, I see. There's yeah,
like
yeah.
A scale, right? I'm like, when he gets to one here, the video's gonna end. And that, no. I was like,
no, my skill level is not good enough yet.
I clearly need to practice Mega Man more. My skills are not quite sharp enough.
I'm just going back on record that I'm having a lot of fun, but I still think this is a terrible idea.
What is there but fun?
Because in, like, 3 hours when we're still here...
This is fine.
I felt a bit of it.
I didn't do anything.
I'm getting angry at Mega Man now. And I can't end the video, so I'm fucked.
I get this part blind. Watch now.
Oh, here we go. Oh, no. We should have given him some.
Am I over that reason?
Yeah, you're at the final boss.
There you go. You're over it now. We should have given him some reason to win. You know, something to fight for.
I don't know where. Okay, I'm here.
You actually weren't doing that. What? Yeah, but the reason to win is because if he doesn't, it's frustrating, right? Like.
Yeah, I know, but I feel like it would have been even more frustrating if at the end there was something that he wanted, you know?
So what, we like slap him with a fish?
But no, that was one idea I had 7 years ago.
And you've not topped it, so. Yeah. That, I hate that.
No.
I hate fine. That fish slapping thing. It's not uploaded anymore, so we probably shouldn't talk about it, but like, we could have done so much more with it.
What?
We could have been the fish slap guys, and look at us now.
I don't know, I mean, it was fun that one
yeah,
time.
Yeah, one slap is fine, and then...
And like, also, like, the fish had been in Mike's fridge for, like, 10 years or something. But, like, I don't know if I want to be, like, impacting the amount of fish that get taken out of circulation, because they're all slapping us.
As you can see here on the chart, the number of fish that are bought in the market.
Local rises. Bass population is down yeah. Since YouTube sensation Cameron has been slapped by Cameron. 700.
He's so well known, they only know his first name. He's like Cher or Prince. Yeah.
I wish we had just called our kid Trout Cameron.
The YouTuber formerly known as Cameron.
Fine, I'll shoot them.
If I ever regret, okay. We wanted to do live action One Runs.
That was going to be my whole thing.
Yeah. It's a shame that that's one we never
were. I had an idea for us to like hire out like a hall and then try stand up comedy, but if nobody invite all our friends, but if nobody laughed at a joke, the video would
My god.
Cameron experiences one of his worst nightmares and then the video ends at some point.
I love that. So it's like quick items.
Oh.
All right, maybe we can do that for the Subway Surfers Arsehole channel. We're not doing that. I'm trying to make that very clear. We're going to make sketches. Go to youtube.com/commit to the bit. We're doing sketches. That's what we're doing.
We love sketches.
Yeah.
They're our friends like Mega Man is. Hang on. Oh, almost.
Would you do it, Cam? If we, let's say hypothetically, we were able to set that up, would you do it?
Oh, God. Who's in the audience? Is it Randall's or is it?
It's our friends, the best friends, your wife, your mother's there.
I guess I would do it then. I guess that would
my,
be
my best friend, your mum.
Yeah, I guess I would try. Because I think I could make them laugh a bit, you know?
A bit.
But not strangers. Strangers. Because there is...
not strangers.
It's easier to make...
Strangers.
It's easier to make people you know laugh. Because you can kind of play on the fact that they know you and it's a weird thing you're doing, you
I
know?
Suppose, but I also think...
I mean, this guy's out of a duel.
Surely, he can't have that many pickaxes left.
This is like the last time recent I played... Cuphead, and we were convinced that if we killed enough of the enemies, they'd stop coming. If you watched that video for a long time, we're just on one screen.
There it is. I'm learning. I'm adapting. I'm overcoming.
Yes, get him for it.
We could have had so many separate one runs out.
Just call me Tom Cruise because I'm live, die, and repeating, baby. Where's Emily Blunt?
Where is she?
Where is Emily Blunt?
She's living the best life.
Mm. Isn't Emily Blunt been cast in something very recently?
She was Mary Poppins, wasn't she? Mm.
She was, yes. That was a good sequel.
That was. That's one of my biggest regrets.
What?
Not getting cast as Mary Poppins.
Oh.
Yeah, you were close. Yeah, yeah. It was doing the final two.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, she's good. Like, Emily Blunt was fine. I just think I could have brought him into it. Unique, you know?
Yeah, it was a shame that she had to like, really disfigure your face.
I know.
To try and stop it, you know?
Because you looked exactly...
like Emily Blunt.
I couldn't remember who played. Is it Julie Andrews?
Yes.
It's just not fair. I just, you know. It's fine. Like, I'm happy doing this shit with you guys, but, you know, maybe.
It's just like what could have been.
Yeah.
You know?
I could have been Mary Poppins and she could have been One Run. Do you guys?
Oh my god. Imagine me and Cam doing One Run with Emily Blunt. that's a different universe.
So intimidated the whole time. So, Emily, what games do you want to play?
Why did you make yourself the fucking weirdo in this hypothetical?
I would be so nervous if Emily Blunt, superstar Emily Blunt, would be there.
I mean, I don't...
Like, what does,
yeah, like, I wouldn't...
What does John Krasinski smell like?
I don't know if... Maybe I shouldn't say this story.
Go on, get out, then I'll rage.
It's like bubbling. I guess I just won't say the name. I think you guys will know who I'm talking about, but people watching this won't. So we have a friend who met a sort of pseudo celebrity, and I
don't know who this is.
Maybe you will when I say the next part. I just don't want to. I'm being vague for okay. That piss is sick because I joke.
I didn't know I had a dog.
I didn't know you had a dog either.
Yeah. Dog is Mega Man's best friend. So am I.
Mega Dog is Mega Man's best friend.
Ergo, I hate dog. Yeah, we had a friend who met like a pseudo celebrity who, like, is known for looking very suave, shall we say? Like,
okay.
It has a reputation for being very classy and very suave. And I was, and I just as a joke was like, "What do you smell like?" And the friend had an answer.
Oh,
immediately.
Interesting.
Just immediately was like, really good, actually. Which means they noticed.
Yeah. I mean, I think sometimes people do smell really good. Like,
yeah, sometimes, yeah,
really
you
good.
Just notice, like
yeah.
You don't notice somebody smells normal, but you notice they smell bad or good.
Yeah. It was JT and Hugh Jackman. Just,
if JT had met Hugh Jackman and we didn't know, that would be wild.
Yeah, that'd be wild.
He would
that
be like,
would rock my world.
I feel like you would mention that every single time. You'd be like, "Hi, my name is Jack. I met Hugh Jackman."
Yeah, it's like it's on his like Twitter. In his bio, is like Jack have met Hugh Jackman. Number of times met Hugh Jackman. One.
It's on his what?
Oh, yeah.
Oh God. We should have speculated that he couldn't complain about you. This video would have been over.
Big time.
You are so right, Cam. There is like.
Welcome back to One Run. Today I'm playing Sonic Adventure, but if I die, the video ends. Count me down, Reese.
3, 2, 1, gotta go fast!
Game.
Let's get him!
Nice. I think it just goes straight in, so we should start there.
Oh, Sorry.
What?
I just cracked my chair a little bit and it sounded like a fart. It sounded like a toot.
If you just farted, it's fine.
I mean, I would tell you guys if I farted.
You once edited a fart out of a VOD.
Yeah, well, that was an unintentional fart.
Okay, sure.
Are all your farts intentional?
Most of them.
Are you like, time to fart?
I usually hear a fart come in, you know, and I'm like, ooh, here it comes. Let me do something funny. Yep, it certainly is. It speaks volumes that you can never tell whether it's a dub or not with this game, you know?
You can't tell if this is a dub!
No, I mean like a YouTube dub. Like,
guys, I think that hedgehog is talking.
Fucking hell. You abandoned me, and I most needed you.
It's chaos.
I'm sorry about the audio thing on the screen, guys. I'm trying to get it right that we can hear it, but it's not feeding into the mics. Also, just full-on military in a Sonic game.
Yeah. I mean, is this before or after the, like, Sonic, like, marries a human woman?
This is way before.
Okay.
Why does that matter? What, they went about guns after that?
Well, no, I'm just saying, if this was after that, it wouldn't be as weird as him marrying a full-on Final Fantasy human.
Fucking Sonic. This is technically 2003, 2002.
1986.
We're playing the remaster, but I think the game originally is from 1999, I think.
Oh, wow, so it was like a PS1 game, was it?
Dreamcast. Although this version released on GameCube.
Oh, yeah!
All right, Cam.
Here we go, Cam. Luck. It's up to you now, boy. Yeah.
Save Station Square from Chaos. Or, I mean, I guess you don't know who he is right now.
Sounds like you were trying to disguise yourself from saying PlayStation. Save Station.
Get him, Cam. Fuck him up. Look out!
Okay.
Oh,
God.
He's gonna have you!
Oh, God. I could actually die. I'm not gonna be able to tell my funny Sonic story.
It's alright, dude. We still got Elden Ring. We'll always have it.
It's not gonna be relevant!
A and A, but get a ring. A and A, but get a ring.
It was A! I don't play Xbox!
Look down! X and X! Get a ring! X and X! Why looking at him? My God! Jesus, are you going to be the first person in the world
to lose the Chaos?
Yeah!
This is Chaos! Oh, God. Is he dead?
What do you think, Cam?
He's moving!
Do you not see the health bar on the screen?
Nice, good shot. Nice.
Wait. Okay, I'm not going to tell my story until I beat Chaos, because I feel like I'm going to die! Where's he going?
He's jumping around. Now!
You did it!
Hey! Is he dead?
I don't want to play with you, Sonic.
Now, you may think that that's just the jank of the remaster, but it was like that on the Dreamcast.
He's some kind of eldritch horror in this game.
Yeah, he's like a Betty Boop cartoon.
Like, he can never like stay still.
Yeah.
He's constantly like, oh, Sonic, you can't say that. Come on, novella.
I told you, this game's old.
It's from a different time.
Yeah. And now for one of the most confusing cuts ever.
Okay. Oh, nice. Excited, I don't remember this at all.
Nice dolly out into a crate. Nice. Oh.
Like, Sonic could definitely hear that. He laughs at the top of his voice. Also, why is he up there?
I don't know if I knew, like, a guy laughing at me from above me on a skyscraper.
You don't spend enough time near skyscrapers, Cam. Yeah. You can always hear them.
The fact that Sonic
Jack constantly hears people laughing at him.
Oh, here comes Tails.
What a tonal change this is. He just ditches it in the water. Oh, he does ditch it in the water.
Tails!
You silly goose!
You might be dead!
You caused $8 million worth of destruction!
What am I gonna do with you? Always crashing planes!
Big woman.
Man, she was hot at one point.
What do you mean?
Like,
well, her and her twin.
Yeah, legit. Like, at one point in my life, I remember going, oh, damn, like, cool.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. And now,
so
look.
So wild.
Yeah.
So, here's my Sonics.
No, you can do it.
Carry on.
You just gotta rescue Tails, he's dead. Get his corpse, take him back to his family.
Yeah, bring him back to his family so they can have closure.
Yeah.
In true one-run fashion, I feel like we had to do this at least once during this last session, This is a story making fun of JT. He's not here to defend himself.
That's another one of my regrets to finish the Mega Man. I'm sad we never got JT on.
Oh, yeah. We could have gone tonight. Yeah. He asked us if we want to play games. Yeah. We should have gone like, yeah, we can play games if you record it.
Yeah. We can play games. We're actually playing like a fun one, like in Jack's house. If you want to come in, just like...
We're playing Sonic Adventure. You love that.
You love Sonic, right? And I would just tape him to a chair.
I don't know if he'd fit, though, now that the setup is different.
Yeah, JT's really let himself go.
Yeah.
I don't think you're going to be able to tell this story.
Welcome back to One Run. Today we're playing Plate Up, but if we fail, the video ends. Count us down, Jack.
3, 2, 1, go! And you have to press.
That's right, that's right.
You guys did it! That was perfect. Yeah, there was no... you didn't say count me down, you said count us down.
I recently watched the one where I fucked it up, so I felt real real passionate about getting it right.
Put some coffee, F.O.
Wait, do you watch our videos?
Yeah.
Ugh.
Oh shit, he wants coffee too.
Yeah.
I would have thought
people coming for coffee. You gotta take the order first, Cam.
Yeah, you
wait, I've taken his order.
No, you haven't.
The bell is the order.
Oh.
Yeah, he wants one coffee. There we are.
You can take an order while holding something, just so you know.
I can only apologize. We picked coffee because we thought it would be funny. However, we realize now that this is going to take 45 minutes.
Well, I can clean. That'll be entertaining for people to watch.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Everyone loves
coffee.
Those cleaning videos on YouTube get millions of views.
Yeah.
Coffee.
It doesn't even go cold. Like,
really?
Yeah. You can just.
I'll drink this one.
You can just churn out coffees, Reese, and they'll just be there when you need some.
Coffee time.
Like, it is so
easy. Want some coffee? Coffees are on me.
Oh my god.
I like so the coffee.
Do they, no wait, doing coffee, coffee,
coffee, coffee.
Now you can take the order while, there you go, look at that, you're getting good at this coffee business, Cam. Look at you.
Coffee.
Can I have some milk with coffee?
No.
You fucking what?
You come here. Disrespect me.
Oh, he's gonna roll this. This guy was fucking milking his coffee. Oh, get him fucking gone.
Doing them and helping him.
You see this here? It says offy coffee. Doing them an offy, that fucking statement.
So.
Offy coffee.
Doing them an offy, you. I cost mine spurial.
We have gone from.
I cost mine fucking cunt. Like that.
We have gone from a video that only people who have seen the bear can find funny to a video that only Welsh people can find funny.
Oh, Cam, put a count to you. Block me in like last time. Get the other side, Cam. Block me in. Okay. If I have to go and talk those fucking customers one more fucking time, I swear to God.
So, here's the downside of coffee. You don't make much money. Like, you made £7 yesterday.
Oh,
so
we're loaded.
You could just move one of the existing counters if you want to get rid of the door.
No. I got a counter man. Like.
You can't pay for it, though.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh,
coffee money don't pay for counters.
Human office. I'll take this one.
Tweet him and Harvey being poor.
Boys, man.
Hey, look at that. We love it. We fucking love it.
Oh, you don't need that bit of the kitchen anyway.
Yeah, fine.
He's slowly closing himself in to the point where it's just all units and a coffee machine.
And like a conveyor belt that brings them out.
Oh, the grabber! The grabber can help us. We still don't know what it is, but...
I want to move this. Oh, sorry, it comes in the way.
I think you can put it in that filing cabinet.
Oh, can I?
You can, but and it'll save it for the next round, but I mean, it's a counter.
Oh.
What you really need to get is another table, because people were waiting for their hoffy-garfy.
The dining table beer can't go on it.
Again, you can't afford it.
Fuck it, it's fine. We can't afford it.
Right, so I'm going to take this. Far there. Move far around there. Hang on.
What is he doing? He's a fucking bad man.
There.
And then.
Pick this up.
Yeah.
Ass.
Get an ass. Nice.
Nice. I'm ready to serve all the coffee you want. Like,
can you imagine how dusty that bit of the kitchen is.
It's fine. Right,
it's like the stock room
coffee.
No one ever goes in.
You made a joke before we started the video.
Coffee,
that
coffee.
This giant kitchen that just makes coffee feels quite backroomsy.
Yeah.
Having a squared off portion of the kitchen that no one can go to really does help with that vibe. Now, as a reminder, Cam.
Yeah.
They have their least amount of patience after somebody on their table has been served. So it's good to try to chain those, you know? Like, taking an order, letting them wait, that's all fine. But serving them is when they get bitchy.
You fucking bastards.
Yeah, there's nothing worse than customers, right? Hey, right, right?
Yeah.
This job would be great if it wasn't for all the fucking customers.
Am I right, TikTok? Am I?
Sorry, what?
That's what all the people on TikTok are like. They're like, I fucking hate people.
Are they?
God forbid I do my fucking job. I'm kidding.
You're on the wrong part of TikTok.
That's not my fault. I'm sorry. I tried. I got off right-wing Twitter. I did. I did it, guys.
I swear I did.
I did, and it dragged me back in. TikTok thinks I'm right-wing again.
Oh, no.
I don't know what it is. I really am not.
Well, it's probably because you keep talking about hating parents and hating kids and
you know what?
Hating pretty much everyone. Hate everyone?
Yeah, I'll tell you what you can't stop the right wing doing, Cam. Well. Birthing. So if anything, my irrational...
I don't want to have this conversation.
This is why I wasn't allowed to work at the coffee place.
You recognize how Reese has just been quietly doing his job?
I like drinking coffee. You want coffee? You want coffee? I put a coffee there for you.
This is the simplest shop we've ever run.
Yeah.
Going from, cousin, get out of the fucking way! Let me out of the fucking kitchen! To, hey, they need another coffee again.
They need another coffee, yeah.
One of the four cold cups of black coffee. They want one of them. There you go. You made £8-9.
Yes.
You fucking rock. Sorry.
That's what I like to see.
Sorry.
Still can't afford.
Should we just start again?
Let's go.
Let's go again.
Let's keep serving these fuckers.
Yeah, these fucking customers.
Coffee's up.
Oh, you're cooking coffee today.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I feel it mixed up a bit. So I got coffee. Oh,
some coffee today.
It is the least intense thing.
Yeah.
I've cleaned more spills than I have served customers.
Where are these spills coming from?
This guy's just like...
Me and Shahar did a
He loves coffee so much, he's coming all over the place.
Reese is really good at making coffee.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. I don't know if you wanted that, but you really did.
I like the idea that you give them a menu and it's got one thing on it.
Americano?
No, wait. This place does coffee?
Also, because there's no milk. Like, is it just Americanos and espressos?
It's literally just black coffee.
Espresso. That's pretty good. Like a coffee that makes you...
What?
Feel like yourself. I don't know. Swing and a miss.
Oh, right.
They can't all be bangers.
Yeah, no. They can't all be bangers.
It'd be nice if some of them were, though, Cam.
Okay. What did the lion say to the two safari people on a truck?
What did the lion say to the two safari people on a truck?
Meals on wheels. I think we're gonna fail.
No, Cam, the channel's ending. It didn't fail.
This guy's gonna get mad if he doesn't get his coffee soon. He's outside.
He's outside. This is the issue. You guys really need... I think you are gonna fail!
Yeah!
Quick!
Oh, it's fine.
It might work out, but you need another table. Make sure you buy another table.
Oh, not serving anymore tonight, Tony!
Can we just have takeaways? Do we not have any takeaway cups? Oh god, are we gonna fail? Oh my god. We almost lost coffee.
Oh yeah, you need another table like yesterday.
Pronto.
Yeah, but I think you'll get one. They usually give you a table.
God, these guys are the messiest fucking guys. Drink the coffee! Don't spill the coffee. Drink it.
So Shah made an observation because we did a coffee shop as well, and we were shocked by the amount of mess. And Shah made an observation that coffee makes you shit. And is that the joke they're going for?
Wait, did we do it? Did we win coffee?
We did coffee, yeah.
You have an upgrade now. Now, what you can either have ice cream as a dessert, or food burns 100% faster. You cannot burn coffee. Get another table, you fucks.
Is this a table?
That's a table.
There's a table in the kitchen.
Oh, no! What are we going to do?
What do you mean?
You can't get it over to me. Can you put it on the...
Hang on.
Can you put... Oh, there you go.
They like there was no option. There's just no way!
There's just no way. How do I put it down?
Square, I think. A? X? There you go.
That one.
Having to translate...
I meant to, like, buy it.
Oh, you put it down and then press square.
Oh, right.
There you go. All right, you're back in the money, boys.
We're in the money.
I don't trust Camera anymore. I'm gonna open up the door.
You've released the spirit.
You just hear.
What's wrong with me, Reese?
I want to move.
I want to move.
I want to move about, like, you know.
Now, Cam, if you want to have a bit of style about yourself,
yeah,
you can do something about your hair. But you can also go up to the chairs.
Oh, never mind.
Why don't you do something about your hair?
Oh, never mind, man. I don't want a door.
You tried to get out, Reese.
Let me out!
I wouldn't let you.
I don't want to make coffee anymore! I want to be a baker!
You know, you can cut
I want to be a Michelin star chef, and you ruined that for me! You ripped that dream for me!
No one
Hello
would.
And welcome to Halfie Coffee.
No well, fuck you, I'm a fucking car.
No one would ever hire a pumpkin to be a baker.
Whoa! It's day 4, Cam.
You said that like it's the year.
That was the joke.
Oh, sorry.
You said that like it's the year. Now, Cam, if you go up to a chair and interact with it, you can...
I know!
Then do it.
I don't want to. I want as many people as possible to get coffee.
Group sizes are 1 to 2, so the chair's always going
to
be...
Well, maybe I want to move the guy who's by himself drinking coffee to interrupt these two people's date when they're having a real serious conversation about commitment. Maybe Gary over here, who's read a little bit too many conspiracy theories on YouTube, needs to talk to them.
Why are you talking like that?
Alright, I know you're mad that the spirit got out, but you don't need to take it out on me, okay? Alright? I'm just here to help.
I'm not alright.
It's okay.
I don't forgive you.
There's pirouetting in the car.
I'm the one who's raided up.
No, he wasn't criticizing you. He was telling you he's pirouetting. This stupid thing. My thing! Doesn't mean anything to anybody. I don't think the camera picked that up.
That's fine.
Wait, do they want coffee?
I don't know. Yeah,
oh,
turns
wow.
out. Turns out they do. They hoffy coffee, much like most people do.
Yeah.
But you know what they do that most people don't do?
What?
They make a fucking mess. They shit all over my cafe.
Now.
I paid good money for this coffee guy in the back.
This coffee pumpkin.
I mean, I paid him once and then I locked him in, but I paid him a lot of money that one time.
Excuse me. One day I'll get out of here and I'll become a pastry chef. One day.
One day I'll be a real pumpkin.
Oh my god! Is that a pretty good joke? Is that good enough?
What?
What joke are you making?
Oh my god! Because he's a pumpkin. He's a god.
God with an R. Okay, sure. Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I knew I could do it.
This kind of joke that probably works better in text, I would have thought.
Well. Agree to disagree.
Do you want me to subtitle it so everybody's watching?
No,
they'll
joke. Get it. They'll get it.
Comment below if you got it, and comment below if you didn't get it.
Look, if you watched Halloween Town when you grew up, you'll get it.
What the fuck is Halloween Town?
You never saw Halloween Town?
Have you seen Bad Boys 2?
There is a Halloween Town 2.
Have you seen that?
No.
You ain't seen Halloween Town 2!
Halloween Town is a movie that's vaguely reminiscent of Hocus Pocus. And at the end they fight a giant pumpkin called the Pumpkin Lord or the Pumpkin King or something.
I just want a smash cut from, like you guys said, Cousin! To the Pumpkin King is actually the villain of Halloween 1.
Should I tell my Sonic story in this video or is it too late?
I would, yeah, go for it.
So it's not as funny anymore because you can't see Sonic on the screen.
I'm sure people can imagine Sonic.
So you know the new Scott Pilgrim TV show that they've put out on Netflix?
The, like, anime?
Yes.
Is it out?
It is, yeah.
Oh, mm-hmm. Sick.
So in it, they changed some things, obviously, because they wanted it to be fresh.
It now stars Sonic the Hedgehog.
But you know the Puckman, Pac-Man fact that he tries to impress Ramona with at the party? Yep. They changed it to a Sonic the Hedgehog fact. He goes up to Ramona and he's like, did you know that in the 90s there were two different Sonic cartoons that were running at the same time and the same guy voiced Sonic in both of them? And when that happened, JT went, oh, you'd have me. Like, the fact that's supposed to be lame worked on JT.
I mean, I like the Pac-Man fact, if I'm being honest. I'd find that interesting. Why did they change it? Why did they change it, though? It's wrong.
I think Ryan Liam Ali and Edgar Wright were like, we don't want to make the same thing again. Like, let's do some fun new jokes.
I want the same thing again. I just want to play the exact same game I've always played.
Don't watch this, then, because it's very different.
Ah.
It's good. It's really good.
Nah.
Do you want breadsticks?
they can stir their coffee with breadsticks.
It just doubles their patience, but you're not struggling with it at all. I mean, I would just get another table.
We need something to, like, cool the people off outside, because we're not struggling with the people inside.
Well, another table will help with that.
That's true.
He just dumping it over.
There you are. One day I'll get out of my prison cell.
That's such a terrible layout.
Okay, let's actually...
Zero! Never seen zero.
One day... I'll get out of this place one day.
Oh, that's pretty good. I mean, I can't collect many coffees.
But aside from that, it's pretty good.
Okay, hold on.
You can't put a chair right by the door.
We don't want to.
I would help if I could. Oh, I can now.
Fuck.
Cammy's getting out. Stop it.
No!
Suddenly.
The side story every time a musical.
Suddenly, I'm free.
Oh, Cam, you're gonna have to get a new pumpkin in.
Fuck.
It's the only way. Lock him in. He's back.
Put a chair in the door.
I know my place.
The sad story of Stockholm syndrome.
Do you know that's not real?
Stockholm.
Yeah, the city of Stockholm isn't real. No, Stockholm syndrome's not real.
You would say that, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Trapping me over here.
It's not even a real thing, Reese, so I don't know what you're complaining about.
What do you mean it's not real?
So, the origin of Stockholm Syndrome is... again, feel free to correct me in the comments.
I'm sorry.
It's totally fine. It's hot. So there was... In Stockholm, there was this guy that tried to rob a bank. Right? And it all went tits up. And he ended up taking hostages in the bank. And he wasn't cruel to the hostages. He was just really afraid of being caught, you know, and going to jail. So he was like, I gotta take these hostages, right? Not a cool thing to do. But he wasn't, like, threatening to kill them or anything.
Well, we've all been there.
The police did such a bad job. They wouldn't negotiate with him. They were asking, like, the hostages to negotiate for them. And they were constantly firing into the building and almost hitting the hostages. Whereas, like, the guy who was kidnapped them promised them he wasn't actually going to hurt them. He was just really scared and he didn't know what to do. So
I like the sound of this guy.
Yeah, I mean, he still did a bad thing, but you know, he wasn't like, you know, a murderer or anything.
Is robbing a bank a bad thing though? Who are you hurting?
I don't know.
Who are you hurting?
That's true. I mean, I guess the hostages put going through a traumatic experience. But anyway,
it sounds like it went alright for them.
The police.
Like he wasn't causing the traumatic experience.
The police handled it so terribly that when they eventually got the guy and the hostages all got out. None of them wanted to press charges and none of them wanted to go to court to, like, be a witness for the police because they hated how the police handled it. And they all actually, like, raised funds to get his bail because they thought he you know, did such a better job than the police. And the police were so
at
angry.
What?
Well, at, like, not shooting them.
I'm also really good at that, actually. It's one of my skills.
But they were just pissed off at the police, basically. And they
so
were like,
great
this guy...
Bank robber, never shot anybody.
And because of this, the police turned to, like, a psychologist and were like, can you explain this? And he was like, I guess maybe they fell
maybe
in love with him.
Stockholm syndrome.
Maybe they went mad and there was actually a mental defect or whatever. So then this guy came up with Stockholm syndrome to explain why this happened. But apparently it was just like, no, they just genuinely, it was a terrible situation. And the police commissioner is actually quoted as saying, we don't care if the hostages die as long as he...
I actually got a little bit excited. Okay. Oh my god. He can do that?
I'm like, wait, I wonder if I can...
The plot thickens.
Now I'm the man in charge.
You let your guard down talking about Stockholm. And
I will win the day.
Reese. There will be consequences. There will be hefty... Just because you don't press the thing.
I don't think it'll matter.
Affordable. Come here, Reese.
He's about to take some hostages.
I'm building you your new kitchen.
Why? It's like
hang on. I do that even more dungeon-y. No.
Get in. Get in. You son of a bitch.
No! Don't plug me in! What about my wife?
Ready up.
What would I do?
How much he's refusing to sing along?
This is all you get! Your empty promises to me! As empty as these cups on the counter!
Make the fucking coffee.
No more! No more will I be treated like this! Under your tyrannical rule, I say no!
Make the fucking coffee! I'll come over there, I'll rip your fucking throat out!
You cannot get to me! This impenetrable shield you've put around me is also saving me.
I swear to fuck.
Free to pirouette around to do what I want to do in life.
I'm gonna fuck
you. I wanted to be a baker. Yes. I wanted to make sweet pastries for all people, not just the people who like coffee like you. Fuck you son of a bitch.
Russell Crowe sounding motherfucker.
84631.
I don't care what your fucking phone number is. I'm gonna fucking kill you. If you don't give me coffee right now, I swear to God.
And I'm Chavez.
You're gonna be like fucking Footloose in this motherfucker.
Don't you forget my name.
I don't even know what your name is.
Any day now, you'll be bankrupt, old man. You have nothing. Nothing but your stupid glasses.
I swear to God, I'm gonna eat you. I'm gonna fucking eat you.
I will
from
be free.
Tip to fucking sternum.
I will be free.
You son of a bitch! You fucking taste
I win!
Look at all the... Look at the caps. All the caps on them.
The restaurant's supposed to close. The headline does,
yeah,
not,
so I went
does
to,
not tell the whole story.
I went to Hoffy Coffee.
A new place? It just opened a week ago?
Yeah. It's weird. They have like this whole thing for the kitchen, but the guy who made the coffee is just trapped in. Are you singing?
You can't see either of them, but you can hear them.
You can see the counter, right? So the people.
Yeah, oh,
see,
yeah.
They can,
yeah,
see all of
so
that.
They see the whole thing.
It fucking killed me that you would not sing along.
Welcome back to One Run. Today, I'm playing Cluster Truck, but if I don't redeem myself, the video ends. Count me down, Jack.
3, 2, 1, go. Cam.
Careful, yep. careful.
It's, please stop making that video sick.
Oh, make me sick as well.
Cam.
It's
not a speed run. I want to remind you of that. We may have had to scrap a recording, which is why he's being very, very calm.
Yes.
He didn't
yes.
fail. There was an issue with the settings.
I couldn't move.
Yeah.
My camera.
Yeah. All right, Cam.
Yeah.
Chill. This isn't a game where you necessarily have to go really
quick.
He's
yet to jump as well.
I was hoping he would be less chill than this.
Be chill, but also, like, try a little bit.
Like, make a video. Yeah, yeah. There's a middle ground, Cam, you see. There's a middle ground between jumping fucking straight off a truck onto the ground and doing nothing.
You have to jump?
Okay, well. Oh! Hello and welcome to One Run, where today we're playing Elden Ring, but if I die, the video ends. Count me down, Reese.
3, 2, 1, go!
And also count me down, Cam.
3, 2, 1, go!
Alright, well.
I just wanted to have you both do it.
Just makes my one a little less special, it's fine.
Do it better, Cam. Do it better than Reese did.
Cam could never.
Oh, wait.
Who's better at counting you down?
I just realized something. This isn't a bit. I know I said I had a plan, but this wasn't it. You have to die in this tutorial.
No, you don't.
Yeah, you do. I mean,
They've never done that before, though, I thought. I thought there's always a way to beat the boss.
I mean, I guess there's technically a way, but most people consider it a scripted death.
Oh, shit.
Well, we can't scam out of two videos. We've already done the sun's other, the car one. Really.
Yeah. I mean,
wait, there's literally no way to beat it.
There is a way, but it is, like, nearly impossible. Like, it's very, very, very hard. I don't.
listen.
Look, it's
over 10 years ago, I became friends with Max Payne. And it's been so long that he's now Max Payne 3. I truly believe that you have the experience now
Where is this going?
to to do this.
Right, you're right.
I am Max Payne 3.
I just realized that before the video started, and I was like, I'm going to work that joke in. And I didn't do a good job, but I said it.
No, you didn't do a good job. You did a great job. I'm beating this boss. Sorry, everyone. Come here. I'm having you.
Alright, he doesn't look that bad. He looks like a standard Dark Souls. Oh, he's got a lot of arms. Okay. He's got a lot of arms.
You've already taken... No, you're not doing anything.
No, I'm good.
Fine.
I mean, what's more pressure? This or the last video? As in, not the last video, but the last video.
The last
video.
I think
video.
He still kills you even if you beat him, mind. But are we just going to say if I get him to zero health, that kills?
I mean, fuck it, yeah. Whatever. It's not like the rules matter anymore.
Then why can't I die to him?
Because it doesn't feel satisfying. Yeah.
Oh, she's kind of bad, though.
What?
Look. No spider.
No spider has ever turned me on. I can say that confidently.
What about, like, Andrew Garfield? Fuck me! Andrew Garfield, please!
What about, like, the arachnoid in Doctor Who?
No, dude, what? She's like, screaming.
You're telling me you wouldn't? Come on. You're telling me you wouldn't?
People are going to be so disappointed.
No, dude, it's great.
It's great.
It's great!
Yeah, this is the last Souls type of video we'll ever do.
Yeah,
I know.
And it's going to have the most Souls-like ending. Oh, what a dodge. What a fucking dodge! Here's the thing. If you weren't really good at these games...
I feel this is rigged.
If you weren't really good at these games, I wouldn't have suggested it.
I'm not really good. Well, I didn't die.
Right? It didn't say you died.
It doesn't. It's a cutscene.
Oh, let's see. Let's see what happens. If you die in the cutscene, you die in real life.
I guess it's not a death. It's a loss. Because you don't die canonically in the game. You get thrown off into the water.
Let's see what happens.
We're currently nothing.
Yeah. Oh, this is how the game ends, by the way. It's really short.
It is still working, because the top right is like...
It's really struggling.
Okay.
Now, I may look dead.
But you do get up from it.
Yeah. So I think we're good. I think canonically, we don't die.
We'll judge it based on what it looks like.
It's not like Bloodborne where you do actually die and go to like the Hunter's Dream.
Go to Doll Heaven.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, dude. Yeah. She also be kind of
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, like a spider. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, should I just skip the cutscene?
No. I want to see. If you get, like, revived, then I don't think it counts.
Who has hairier arms? Me or him?
Who looks more like a horse? Me or him?
You don't want to know.
Come on, there's only a couple of videos left. Let's not go there.
Yeah, we've come this far.
See, fortune's on my side.
Okay, wait. If she casts some kind of fucking magic...
And brings you back to life,
then
that's a death.
Then you're dead.
Alright.
Found him here after all.
No, I'm alive! I'm groggy!
Oh, yeah, he's alive!
Fucking baby! And I'm skipping the cutscene.
Oh, wait. Okay, you gotta promise me that she didn't cast some kind of spell, though.
Oh, I don't know if she casted a spell, but I was still alive.
Yeah, but you could have been dying, like...
Dying is not dead. Trust me.
Okay. Now go down the hall.
Yep. Okay. We're in.
Let's go, baby!
I'll talk about my plan when we get there.
Okay.
Because otherwise this video is gonna be the longest thing in the world. But this is the tutorial, and I'm not scared.
You don't usually jump down this hole, though, do you?
This is the tutorial hole. It was so easy to miss that they had to patch in like a thing on the screen to tell people it's there.
Go down there.
Yeah, and I should have fucking shown you guys. There's a guy there.
Yeah,
who's like,
go down the hole.
Just jump down the hole, but it's just sounds like a trap. So I didn't go down there. I was like halfway through the game when I found out there was a tutorial down here.
There's like. There's a real problem with them like having a reputation for fucking you over, so there's no time like a Souls game could ever like be honest, because it's just boy who cried wolf.
Absolutely. I know, I'm an elder boy.
Oh,
I am. So, much like Dark Souls, the club feels real strong.
JT's been preaching the Church of the Club for years, and you only recently got on it.
Yeah, you know, better late than never, that's what they say. As long as you accept Jesus right before you die, it's fine.
What?
I don't know.
That's what they say.
I don't know. Clubbing in your late 20s feels bad.
You still do it, though.
We do it, but like, I don't feel good afterwards.
I remember there was a night out where everyone was ready for bed, and Reese Peak was like, I'm going back, boys. I'm fucking going back.
Stop it. Dude. Come on.
My problem is I just stopped paying for everything. That's why I don't want to go.
Dude, that
I've paid for like fucking eight people's entrance into a club once.
Oh my god.
Come on, I'll fucking pay, it's fine.
Drunk Reese Peak is a very generous
I'm a great guy when I'm drunk.
when I'm drunk.
When I'm drunk, yeah. I saw a photo that was like, are you fun to be around? And it was like, 0 to 2 drinks, no. 2 to 6 drinks, yes. 6 plus, no.
Mine's like that, except it's no for all.
6 drinks, though? No.
Nah, not really. Like, 6 drinks can be a problem.
Ooh.
But, like, you know, you've had 3, so you're fine. No, I'm just trying to get to 6 drinks at that point. What about when you're so... No.
Just nah. No. Just stop asking. Stay away from
me. It's embarrassing for both of us at this point.
As I said in a previous one run, I recently got a new job, and as part of that, I had to tell new people that I don't drink. And it's always a weird experience, because people just assume that people do. Yeah. But I had maybe the strangest reaction I've ever had in my entire life, which was I said, oh, I don't drink. And they're like, oh, you don't drink any alcohol? And I was like, yeah. And they were like, what do you drink?
Anything else?
What question is that? Like, do you guys sustain yourselves just on alcohol itself?
Yeah, what you didn't know is that person's an alcoholic and they only drink that.
Also, like, the like follow-up question, like, what, you don't drink? Like, I don't drink. What, alcohol? Like, you were saying, no, I just never drink it.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's what they took from it, based on the rest of their question.
So what do you drink?
They were like, what do you drink? And then they asked me what my vice was, and I was like, look down. Look up, what do you think my vice is?
I just can't stop going to the gym.
I'm addicted to the grind.
Yeah, I have the body of a Greek god, that's my vice.
Yeah.
So, like...
I want to get it going, you know, as a big boy. I want to get it going, the phrase, I have the body of a Norse god.
Oh,
I feel
fuck
like,
yeah.
I feel like you can get away
I have the body of Thor.
Yeah, I was going to say, Thor is really doing a lot for the big boy cosplay community.
Yeah. Oh!
Oh, fuck. I'll tell you what, starting with that armor definitely makes this guy more of a threat than he was when I fought him.
Yeah, but if you die here, it feels satisfying.
That's right? Fine,
yeah. Yeah, sure, satisfying. He's one of the easiest first bosses in any Souls game.
I feel like you did a better job fighting Spider-Woman.
Yeah, well, I've been more careful, honestly.
Well, guys, I hope you've enjoyed our Souls-type video, because this is the last one, and we're done.
Yeah, that was us.
I've never seen someone hit someone with a club so hard. It went in them.
Yeah, in them.
Oh, by the way, guys, now that we're going to end a talkie video, did anyone see... Oh,
so...
Did anyone see that ludicrous display last night?
It's like now he wants to work it in. That's a great trick, guys. So, there is technically another boss right outside, not through this door, but not far from here.
Mm-hmm.
And the game's open world, so you don't have to fight him. And the boss exists to teach you that. It exists to teach you, like, you're not ready, fucking go somewhere else and do something. And I do know that. If we fight that boss, I'm going to die. I think we should go do other open world stuff and see what happens.
Okay. If you feel that way.
All right.
If you don't feel like you're up to it, if you feel like you're not good enough,
it's fine. I'm not good enough. Right, I'll touch some grass. You carry on with your story.
Is this like the bonfires of this game?
Yes.
Cool. Shit, what was I talking about?
You had...
telling people that you don't drink, that was one of them.
Yeah, after that. This is really embarrassing. I guess it would be if you could remember what you were saying.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Wow.
What are we talking about? We're
talking about Dark Souls.
You were like, since this is a talkie video, and then I was like, well, wait a second.
Yeah.
So you probably had a story to tell. Now I don't feel that bad, because you didn't actually say anything.
Since this was a talkie video... I was going to ask you guys.
You guys' weekend.
And then you said, what about that ludicrous display?
Well, did you see that ludicrous display last night?
Fucking VAR ruining football.
He tries to walk it in, right?
Oh, fucking VAR. Wenger. You know, when he stopped managing Arsenal 7 years ago.
So he could, you know, become a player, and now he just walks it in.
Yeah, I think he's like 60 odd.
What were they thinking putting him on?
Oh my god, unbelievable.
Right, so that's the guy, and I am scared of him. So
okay.
we're not going near him.
So, talkie videos, Cameron, is it about, was it anything about JT? Because you like talking about JT quite a lot. You hang out with him quite a bit, more than you hang out with us.
Yeah. A lot of what I want, you know I'm a huge fan of Scott Pilgrim too, but you didn't really invite me to watch
it.
You literally just said, if it's different, I'm going to hate it.
Yeah, but that, wow, so you just decided for me that I didn't want to watch it. It's just like you did with Reese in the D&D movie.
I can't believe it.
Unbelievable.
Can't be brought back up as well. It's too painful.
I know, he told me to do it.
I know, yeah, telepathically.
Yeah, he sent me a message, he was like,
bring it up again.
Go on. Right, what's your story? We can't stall forever, what's your story?
I don't remember. I don't remember. It's gone. Everything's gone.
It was about life. It was about games. It was about
I think
films.
We just need to move
about...
on. I think we just need to be okay losing
No, we
that.
Can't anymore. We need to go back now. We've wasted too much time on it.
But we haven't even seen
no,
a word.
It's been 25 minutes, Cameron.
I didn't say
it's
a single a... word that was relevant to the story
yeah,
I didn't
said,
tell.
Said, yeah, well, you know, but you clearly have something you want to say.
Yeah. You just say it. Whatever it
say
is.
Say to our fucking face. Like,
Jesus. Coward.
I don't remember.
This is what Jen was saying about him not having a backbone, right?
I don't remember.
I don't remember.
I don't remember.
Is there a shittier thing to say than like what I just said? But like,
yeah, there's loads of shittier things. I mean, it depends on the person, right? Because I know that like.
But if I look
that doesn't hit like a sore spot. That doesn't hit insecurity. I'm not like worried every day that I don't have a backbone, you know? I know I don't have a backbone.
Oh my God. They're off.
You know?
I don't know why they do that. It's never explained.
Like to some people like
well, that's just what sheep do.
To some people, like if you call out their weight, it could be the most cutting thing. And then other people it's like, yeah, I know I'm fat, I don't give a shit. Like, you know, I don't think there is a most cutting thing.
No, but like, what is your weakness, though? If you had to...
Well, I wouldn't fucking tell the person that always makes fun of me.
One day I'll get him.
Yeah. Well.
It's like, Superman doesn't go, Lex Luthor, you'll never guess what I hit.
I'm like, in this scenario, you're Lex Luthor. Okay. You've got the hair for it.
Yeah, we have a lot in common. We're both bald, both rich, and we both hit fucking Superman.
Yeah, you both want to rule the world.
Yeah. Only one of those things is true, and it's the bald thing. It's the one I don't want.
Do you see the actor playing Superman is now gotten fucking huge?
Oh my God.
I've seen it for, like, every photo that comes out of him now, he's only wearing, like, oversized clothes.
He's trying to contain
so
it.
So I think, it must be in his contract, James Gunn's like, look, do not show off your body until you fucking...
We need people to come see this movie.
He's huge now, though.
Santa.
Hilariously though, he looks exactly just like Henry Cavill.
He does. He looks so much like Henry Cavill. And like also
it's just Henry Cavill, they don't want to tell us.
He's just younger Henry Cavill. He's like 28, I think.
Hell yeah.
But it was crazy because like he came out of nowhere. I'd never seen him in anything before, and then he just looked exactly like Superman. So I was like, well, I guess they did a good job. Yeah. You know?
And we got Lex as well. We got
Nicholas
Holt.
Witness me!
Yeah, he's bald again.
He's bald.
It's not going to be as good as Mark Zuckerberg, though, is he? I cannot remember that actor's name.
Jesse Eisenberg.
There we go. I had, like, the flip version of the game.
Yeah, dude, Nicholas Holt is great. Like, apparently he's auditioned for, like, every single DC
Batman,
superhero.
Superman didn't get any of them, so he's like...
You know what? Yeah. I'll burn them all.
Yeah. You're the dire hero. You live long enough to see yourself become the villain.
I was convinced. You know when The Rock got real fucking weird about Zachary Levi?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And whatever his film was.
He started beefing it. Yeah, it's Shazam.
Yeah. I was convinced that that was staged. And they were trying to, like, set up a Shazam versus Black Adam movie. And it was all going to be like, you know, they actually don't like each other and now they're going to fight.
Yeah.
But I...
That's actually, in hindsight, I know it's all gone now. That's a great marketing campaign. Treat it like a boxing fight.
Yeah. And I
that'd be sick. Like, have like press events and shit for it.
Yeah.
Because they were both just so happy to be those characters. I really thought they were doing it.
However, with The Rock's background, he would absolutely destroy Zachary Levi in a press conference. What's your power? It doesn't matter what your power
is. Isn't it like one guy's job was to do that?
Yeah.
And the other guy is Zachary Levi.
But the thing is, because that's all dead now, they're not going to come out and say it. They're not going to be like, oh, we had this amazing plan that we don't get to do now. So I still think that was the case, and now they just have to pretend they don't like it.
But the beef happened after both movies were out.
Yeah, that's instead of a sequel.
Oh,
right? Like,
I see. You know, but also both movies fucking bombed.
Yeah, well, that's part of it. But it's just because it's so like kind of out of character, or felt out of character at least for the Rock.
And Zachary Levi, honestly.
Well, it depends on what kind of side you fall on. I think he can do no wrong, honestly.
Oh, jeez.
I don't know what. Oh, well, that'd be up. Hello!
And
welcome
back
to
One
Run.
Today,
we're
playing
N
plus
plus.
But
if
we
die,
all die.
Fuck.
Ah. Hello!
And
welcome
to no. Hello!
And
welcome
back
to
fuck.
Come on!
Hello!
And
welcome
back
to
One
Run.
Today,
we're
playing
N
Plus
Plus.
But
if
we
all
die,
the
video
ends!
Count us down us all at the same time!
3, 2, 1, go!
What a fucking disaster!
It's almost the end!
Okay, Cam, do you want to expand or?
It's almost the end! Now, I do want to say, only one of us has to make it.
Why are we going so fast? Which,
only one of us has to make it.
We have spent the last 2 years.
So if one of us blows up, don't freak the fuck out, okay? Everybody stay calm.
Yeah, just chill. Everyone's fine.
Chill out.
It's just a stupid Let's Play channel, alright? It doesn't matter.
I'm fucking blue this time, so
don't
freak out about it.
It'll be on the screen, don't
worry. If yellow's doing weirdly well, you know why. It's me.
I'm fucking blue.
I'm fucking blue.
I'm just like slowly running out of batteries. I'm fucking blue.
The fucking cam is fucking wrong.
What the fuck is going on?
What is happening? Are we just incredible?
We're just.
Okay.
Unbelievable at this game.
Oh,
and
we
run this way.
What's that Queen song? I'm incredible at this game.
Queen song.
That's a Queen song. Look at us. Who'd have thought it?
Not me.
I've been watching loads of that. This isn't the video to talk
about. Hot Ones?
Yeah, I finally got into it.
Oh, maybe now, the last but one video, we'll talk about Hot Ones. The thing everyone's been wondering, what are their opinions on Sean?
Is he or is he not a good interviewer?
He's good.
I think he's really good. We can't.
I think his name's Sean.
Yeah, I never thought of it like that. Yeah, his name is Sean. My name's not Sean. No, that's the other Jack.
Ha! Is it Jack called Sean?
Yeah, there's a Jack called Sean.
I'm back.
Oh. Hey, welcome back, Reese. Do you know which Jack is called Sean?
What?
Yep.
Sean Astin?
No, not. It's never Sean Astin. I'm sick. You always get Sean fucking Astin, and it's.
How? It's a
guys, oh! I'm gonna miss this.
Yeah.
Let's keep going. Let's not end.
Another absolute year. Right, Reese, you're up for that.
Yeah, I can't wait. Let's do more Mega Man, guys.
Oh, fuck.
Alright, Reese.
Looks like it's my turn to go.
You can do it. Nice. Oh, you're back.
And you're back.
The show must go on. That's the one I was thinking of.
Bye.
Wait for my body parts.
Hey, you're dead.
Oh.
Okay. Nice. And you're back. Now, what were you saying?
And you're back in the room.
The show must go on. That's the Queen song I was thinking of.
Guys, we're
the fucking
legends.
Best, except for the fact that I've died multiple times. Wee.
What a way to go.
Not again.
Crap. My bad.
We're all going too fast.
Why didn't it give us credit for beating that one, then?
Because fuck them.
Them is us.
That's fuck them.
All right, fine. Fuck them. So, yeah, this is the last one video ever on One Run. Ever.
I'm never going to see any of you again.
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
It's Jova, dude.
Mm-hmm. You say it's Jova?
It's Jova.
Is that a Zuma thing? Wow. We're all just speedrunning now. We're all doing it Cameron style.
Cameron.
Ew.
Cameron
we
style.
We hit it Cameron style.
Cameron style. 30 seconds of just okay.
And 2 hours of crying.
All right. How do we... Oh, that's hard.
Remember me!
Who said that? You did nothing. You did nothing.
That was very best.
Right, careful, Cam.
Oh, no!
Wait, just relax. Okay. That's good. That thing at the floor is bad.
I thought he was going to shoot something at us.
No, it's like an angry Roomba.
Oh, he chases us.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Okay, I got the door.
Can I get up from here?
He's got the door.
Whoop. Goodbye. Oh, you're okay. No, never mind.
Bye, Cam.
That was Cam. I was talking to you. Yeah. I thought it was you. Oh, man. God, I can't stand him. I'm glad this channel's ending because I get to spend less time with Cameron.
Guys, make sure to subscribe to mine and Jack's channel.
Commit to
second
the
run.
Oh, that's better. That's better. Don't worry, Cam. We didn't talk about anything.
Hi.
I'm here now.
No, but actually,
you're gonna miss this commentary.
We do have two other channels. You should go check. Oh, you didn't move. Wait, who's blue?
I didn't move because I love the idea, and I'm so angry that the channel is ending tomorrow. And I only just thought of this after Reese did that. We should have done when we die, we actually die.
That's how I want to end the channel. You said no.
No, I mean, like, okay, that's true. You know what?
You're back, Reese.
If anyone's seen the video, the guy who's...
I'm sorry. Let me see back. I'm sorry.
Okay, hang on. Let me get the...
Oh, no.
Oh, fuck me.
Oh, I can't believe you've done this. Come on, Cam. It's all on
okay.
you.
Oh, leg.
It's all on you, Cameron.
Oh, how do I get up there? Is there no way?
Oh my God.
Way.
There is a way.
I can only apologize if my audio is now fucked because I hit the mic by accident.
I think you're okay. Hang on. Yeah, you're fine. They'd be clicking.
They'd be clicking.
Everybody chill.
Oh, they'd be clicking.
Okay. We need to be slow and steady here. Okay? As a team. As one run. A team that will never die. Follow us on youtube.com/committothebit and youtube.com/supermozworld. Nice. He died so we could live. Everything's fine. We mourned you. We were very sad. I cannot believe how well we've done.
He's gonna knock your shelf over and over.
And then there was one. I will carry on in their legacy. What a shame. What a shame it had to end like this. You guys are back!
I saw the koala! I saw the koala!
Right, steady on. Steady on.
Steady on, mate.
Nice. Okay, that works. It's very easy with three people. Even when one of them's Cam.
Wow.
The show must go!
Okay, Cam. Nice.
This is great. Guys, we're never gonna die.
I mean,
one run forever.
This feels good. This feels like, I feel like this is because it was the last but one video. You know, the gods of gaming gave us some. Oh shit! I don't think I should be the one to jump down here.
Well, ooh, very nice. All right, Cam, you're the one to jump down there. Look at that!
Oh my
what
God.
An arc! What an arc this channel has gone on!
I know. Oh shit, this guy!
Okay, you go for the button?
Just go for it, Cam, just get it.
You can get it. Oh, brilliant. Oh my God, dude, that is hot. Alright, good luck, Cam. Oh, look at this! Man, the next video is gonna be a real big disappointment.
No, dude. This is beautiful.
We gotta time this.
This is good.
Yeah, this is
good. Cam, you go first.
Yeah,
go.
Okay, I got this case.
Look at him!
I mean, go for it, Cam.
Yeah. Doesn't even... No. Okay.
Almost. Nice.
You're back.
And you're back in the room.
It's on delayed.
Man, these chairs, they're the ones we used to have when you worked. Yeah, remember when you had a real job? You're a
lazy prick.
And that chair is on its last legs as it is because you swing on it all the time, and I think you're gonna kill it today.
Oh, that would be good, wouldn't it?
Look at it. Oh, he died a hero. My God. I mean, that's not much of a challenge. N++.
I mean, should we just, since it is, we're doing so well, should we just say thanks to everyone who watched? Like,
yeah,
man, if you want. It's been really fun.
This has been a great channel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And despite the fact that I'm glad we're ending. I did enjoy it.
Yeah, it's been a good time.
I mean, I said what I said. I said what I
said. What I fucking said.
I said what I meant in the video. Like, we got the.
You good?
Jesus, is that what it feels? Is that what awaits me?
Go!
I said it in the video. If you haven't watched it, I'll put a card on the screen probably. But like, we just got everything out of this channel, and I'm glad
we
did.
The fact that we struggled so much to choose like what the last videos were going to be probably proves that this is the end.
Yeah. Oh. But like, It's okay. Everything's fine. God damn it. How am I? This is impossible. I can't. Do it for us.
ass, Jack.
There's no way.
The electric. It's keeping me alive, Elizabeth. Jenny.
For one run!
Tell JT I loved him.
Yes! Tell him yourself, Cam. Tell him yourself.
Don't die on me, soldier.
Okay, I feel like this enemy's going to come straight for us, so be ready.
Yeah.
Oh, so, okay, it's missiles. It's not too bad.
Oh.
Oh, my leg.
Oh, I almost cramped my leg. Huh?
Reese isn't going to make it the rest of the season. What does the box do?
What does the box say?
What does the box do?
Oh, no.
You seem to be very alive right now, Cam.
Oh, no. Ave Maria.
Hello, and welcome to the final one run, where today I'm playing Fortnite. But if I die, the channel ends. Count me down, both of you.
Three, two, one, go!
This is it, baby!
Let's go!
Final run, baby, let's go!
I am not going Tilted Towers. I'm not doing it. You can't make me.
Reese and I are hyped, and Jack is nervous as fuck.
I am so nervous. Yeah. I've never been this nervous in a video. I just want to be... And it's not about like being impressed. I just don't want the last video to be 20 seconds long.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Let us know in the comments if you get the joke as to why we're playing Fortnite as the last video, because I don't know if we made it clear enough.
No, I feel like we didn't have enough of a recurring joke.
That's a rift, bro.
Yeah, I think it would just put me back in there, I think.
So we're, you know, one run is ending and Fortnite is back on the original map.
Yeah.
Coincidence? Definitely. 100%.
Yeah. Coincidence, or does Epic like us?
Oh, God, dance floor.
No, you know what? Let's not get distracted.
Is like a Plants vs. Zombie there.
There's a zombie?
No, on the wall. It's like a painting.
There we are. That's good.
I'd rather have a sniper, but yeah, I'll take a ranged weapon.
Got some minis. There we are.
Okay. Now.
Lovely jelly. Gonna turn that up.
Oh, you want to see your footsteps?
Oh, I want to turn off music real quick. If I get shot here, it doesn't count.
Oh, yes, it does.
It absolutely does. It would be the funniest way to end the whole channel.
Music off.
Jack dies trying to make the video better.
Okay, we're good.
There we are.
Now, I think that this music will still play because it's part of the map. I just didn't want any copyrighted music to play.
That's fair.
Okay. Whew. Still alive, baby.
I mean, you haven't seen a single person, but still, still alive.
Ooh, very nice.
Do you think people will come to this place to, like, loot it, or is it not a popular spot?
It's pretty close to Tilted, so hell yeah. probably not, no. Or at least not immediate.
Oh, nice.
That's something, isn't
is
it?
Is that jetpack like a jump situation, or is it like infinite?
It's not infinite, but I can float.
Yeah, if you look at the jetpack, is it the green bar, Cam?
Oh, yeah. Cool. That makes sense.
I'll ditch the scope.
You don't want the scopes?
I'd rather have a rocket launcher. It's a great, like, I don't want to do this fight weapon. Yeah.
Fair enough.
Whoa, can you, like, burst through doors?
Yeah.
That's fun.
This game's alright. I think it's going places. It's cool that we get to discover this, like, tiny indie game. Which I say as a joke, but we actually were among some of the first people to play this game.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah.
Really?
We got like a beta key for Fortnite Battle Royale for Arcade Crowd.
Oh, like when it... So we got like a beta key for like the Battle Royale part.
Yeah.
I remember at the time he was little. He's now like a full grown adult man. But my brother-in-law, he got Fortnite when it was like a base building protect game. He was like, oh yeah, it looks like a fun like zombie game. And I was like, oh yeah, it looks alright. Like, and then this happened.
That could be
the first fight.
Bot or bad? Bot.
Wow. Looks like
Could have been a Cameron. Could have been a Cameron.
Bot, bad, or Cameron.
I wonder how many people have thought I was a bot over the years. Yeah. I've got, like, the whole rig, though.
Yeah, I've often wondered that about you as well, Cam. Like, when we played Fortnite together, were they calling on their comms? I think it's a team of bots.
You send me out, and I'm, like, looking at the sky, shooting up, and they're like, oh, it's a bot. And then you guys just jump out and murder them.
That's an idea for a video, right? It's, like, just baiting people into trying to...
It's a shame we'll never see each other again.
Yeah, it's a shame. But somebody else can have that idea for free.
Oh man, it doesn't feel real. It felt really real in the last video, and now it's just like we're playing Fortnite.
Yeah.
It's just because I'm that good, you know?
Yeah, that's true. This skill level. Can you get in the truck?
Maybe.
You are being watched by somebody. The bottom left. just to bug the shield.
Might be the. I guess maybe that wasn't a bot then. If it spectated me, that also could just be somebody else because you can like. Swap
you can swap
players.
Around. Yeah. Yeah, full health.
What are these drinks doing?
Restore my shield.
Oh, cool, cool. So you don't start with full shield.
In zero build, you have a regenerating shield of 50. That's the thing next to my health that looks like a shield. And then you can also have regular shields, which work better.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. That's the regenerating shield is like to compensate for the fact that you can't build anything.
Ah, that makes sense. Yeah.
I quite like it because it means that like you just have a little bit of damage you can take in a fight that doesn't mean you have to heal afterwards. Yeah. Like,
so your health doesn't regenerate.
Take a rift. Go on, take a rift.
Oh, that's cool.
Right, I'll take a rift. I'm feeling it. I'm relaxed now. It hasn't been a 10-second video.
Whoa, what the fuck? You just teleport somewhere?
Yeah, it teleports you straight up.
Whoa.
So you can like glide away. Ooh, that's not car park there, mate.
Yeah.
Is that Homer Simpson's car? I mean, in Fortnite, you never really know.
Yeah, it very well might be.
Oh, no, I'm just gonna try and do it.
Marge, I'm in Fortnite, Marge. I'm on the roof, Marge.
That is absolutely.
Homie! Come meet me at Tilted, homie!
Oh, Jesus Christ.
It's like a gremlin.
You know, they say AI are gonna take our jobs, but I just don't see it.
Okay. Number one victory, Roya!
So you get called red again.
Yeah. I missed out, dude. Like, when they were replacing Justin Roiland, I was two away from getting Morty. I was so close.
Two away, yeah. Man, if only.
Yeah. Imagine the world we could have lived in. Go on, give me your best Morty, Cam. It's the
Rick!
Actually, no,
Rick,
that's...
I'm in space, Rick!
Honestly, that's not bad.
Thanks, dude.
It's not bad for him. I was expecting worse.
Yeah, Morty, let's go!
That's bad. That is bad.
That was the bad one.
Marty, I'm so
that's
sad.
Like, that's like Ken in Aqua's Barbie Girl.
What?
Yeah, come on, Barbie, let's go.
That's Ken? I never knew that was supposed to be Ken this whole time.
She's like, I love you, Ken. And he's like, I love you, Barbie.
That's news to me
as
well.
Oh, my
Ken in
God.
It.
He's just Ken.
I wanna hear that song, but from that Ken.
I'm just Ken. Ooh, that's a good one.
Yeah, it's
that
more
restores
useful.
Both, isn't it?
Yes, it does.
Chuck Jugs.
Hey, like the song.
Like the Fortnite song. We are fucked as soon as I find a player, by the way.
Oh, yeah?
Fine. You got good
weapons. Pretty good against that bot.
It might have not been a bot.
That's true.
Let's not devalue my victory, Royale.
Yeah, Fortnite, we've got to get down.
If we see Omni-Man, I'd be so happy. I just want to see him. I just want to see, like, the random, like, licensed characters running around Fortnite.
The nerves are back.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, there's only 40 people left.
I feel like I'm going to judge you based on who kills you, you know? Like, if you get killed by Squidward, that's a bad
Imagine winning the run in the last, yeah.
Well, I assume...
Reese, you're trying to fuck with him so much.
Never went calm, did that?
Yeah, that's why I'm immune to it. I've already had the worst
I
heated it when it was a 1v1v1.
Yeah. Yeah, the priest that didn't move the fucking dial compared to what Cam did.
I'm just not in that sphere. I didn't realize why that was such a big deal at the time.
You were like genuinely baffled by
the
game.
Yeah.
We're talking about an arcade grab there. This probably isn't. For the final one, Ren, let's reference a channel most people didn't watch. Oh, dude. You know what my favorite Boy in a Bubble movie is?
What?
The Boy in the Bubble.
Nice.
Are these specifically for... Oh, no, they're not. I was going to say these from Jurassic World, but that's not Jurassic World.
Do you know, I actually think these might have come first. When did Jurassic World come out?
2012?
No.
No, it's like 2017.
Okay.
No way.
2016.
That late? Yeah. Then again, it is like fucking 2023 now.
I got nothing else to do.
I got nothing else to do. Yeah, I don't know about this. I'm not sure about this vehicle.
What are the, like... So you can, like, Spider-Man swing off things?
Yeah, this game really early. I want to say...
2015. Yeah. So kind of in the middle of what Cameron and I said.
Yeah, miles away from Fortnite releasing, though. So you guys were, like, almost right, and I was just wrong. I don't know, it just feels like fucking Fortnite's been out forever.
It's probably 2017 or 18.
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah.
I want to say 2018.
Man, there's going to be a 10-year anniversary for Fortnite. How wild
Who's
is
around?
That?
What's happening? Where are the boys? Somebody shot me. Mom!
Oh,
there
my God,
he is.
I mean, that could
that
be
a bot. That's a bot, yeah. He's just standing still. That's a bot.
Oh, so it just cracks open. I thought you were literally invincible then.
Yeah, Seagull Tamer is not a real person.
That home sequel day was like, I hate this game!
Oh my god, it's Super Mario's World! I love one! I doubt it's still the...
Holy shit.
Can you, like, land on that?
I assume I could have.
Yeah, probably.
It's too late now.
Yeah, well, there's some kind of countdown on the character's other party-making screen.
I assume that's when the
map's gonna change?
That, yeah, that hits.
Mm. Crap, what was I gonna say? Yeah, that ball thing, when they first... It was, like, the second vehicle they ever introduced. The first being a trolley.
Oh, I remember that, yeah.
And it was so broken when it launched. Because, like what you just thought, and you're basically invincible when you're inside it. Even if they destroy it. I mean, I doubt it's the case now, but it was when it launched. Even if you destroyed it, you would just pop out with full health.
Yeah.
So it was just like having an invincible health bar, basically. Yeah. Huh. It's kind of sad.
Well.
Camping.
That's right. Dude, every time I see something in this game, I'm reminded that there's, like, full lore and everything. And there are people... Like, that I am to Star Wars, they are to Fortnite. I'm like, that's impressive.
I wonder who's less likable.
Me or a Fortnite stan?
Yeah, well, not specifically you, but I guess specifically you.
Yeah, because if you're going to say Star Wars fans or Fortnite fans, then Fortnite wins the, like, likability contest. There. Yeah. But I think I'm a generally likable Star Wars fan, which is maybe rare.
Yeah.
Yeah, you aren't a dick about Star Wars, I'll give you that. Yeah. Everything else, a colossal arsehole. Yeah. I don't know how you keep it in for the videos.
Yeah, well, as One Run's been proof. I think One Run...
As One Run's been proof.
I think if someone watched One Run, they might get the impression that I'm, like, kind of a bad guy because of how insistent kind we of. Are.
I was going to say, if that's what they think about you, what the fuck do they think about me?
You get away with it a lot, though, on One Run. Like, we talked about this before, like, arcade crowd, I feel like you got it way worse, but now in One Run I've kind of taken a lot of the heat because it's easier to be bite-sized like we're mad at Cameron, whereas the Jack roasting would take place over 30-40 hours.
Oh no.
Okay. Get him. He's in the same situation you were.
Oh boy.
He's got a sniper.
He's real. He's real.
Oh,
he's real.
My god.
Boys, he's real. Boys, he's fucking real. Run. Oh, it's big! I thought it was a throwy!
No, the throwies are like the six packs.
Oh, fuck. Okay. That's okay. He may be real, but I found a sniper! And you know what that also is real? My bullets.
There he is. Oh, he's fighting somebody else.
He's getting third-partied. Hell yeah.
Oh,
I wish, but
that, that would have hurt, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, it was new. Oh, sorry. It looked really
I probably shouldn't have shot. It was... Oh.
Oh, he moved to the final set. That's annoying.
Oh, come on. I mean, I'm being stupid.
That was bad.
I mean, you're alive.
Oh, yeah, fucking hell. I'm just being silly. Do it again. Do it again.
Shot.
Oh,
broken shield.
I shouldn't be stupid.
Oh, you can take Fortnite seriously. That's crazy.
Yes.
You can shoot while... Oh, this is awesome.
I'm hoping I can break the rock.
Yeah.
There's also another guy over here.
I wouldn't guess you could. Is that a banana man?
That was a stupid shot. I'm freaking out. He's still there. Oh.
Do you hide behind the loot box? Yeah. That's amazing.
Oh!
Oh, there we are.